So you're in for a treat. We're having a little bit of audio problem.
No, I think I'm there. Can you guys hear me now?
Oh, here we go. Here we go.
Oh my God. Give me a little anxiety spike at the top. What's up, everybody? Thank you for your patience. Sorry about my fucking bullshit. All right. We're doing it.
Here we are. Newsboyz Nation. Good to see everybody.
I know. We got some familiar faces here. We've already got our hype train up to level 5, which makes
that's incredible.
Me very happy.
We got
to
do something. We have around 800 people in this room. That's okay. Good. Oh, they say I'm quiet. How do I get louder?
I get you. I got you. You don't worry
okay.
about it.
We got a lot of news to go into.
Dude, I know nothing. I know nothing. Have you seen Borat? That's a big one everyone's talking about.
I did. I saw Borat. I watched it last night.
How was it?
I thought it was good.
Does it look like Giuliani's claim? You can give a little spoil. I guess close your ears if you don't want to hear a fucking minor spoiler, right?
Mm-hmm.
Do you buy Giuliani's claim that he was just adjusting his lav?
I sort of do. Here's the thing. Like, I've done a lot of hidden camera stuff. So, you know, it was weird watching this. The first time I saw the Borat movie, like I didn't know anything about hidden camera, but this was 14 years ago. So watching this one, I could see like little edits and like cuts. Uh-huh. Like I was like, oh, okay, well, they're making this look like, you know. And here's, I think the Giuliani thing, look, I think he was definitely down to get a blowjob.
Yeah.
Like
he went into a room with
exactly.
a young woman to take his mic off. Why would you do that?
Exactly. Like he's flirting with her. She asks him to go to his room. Also, he's a guy who just went through a divorce a year ago. Like he's an old, gross looking man. If there's anyone that's like into like blowing him, he's going to be like, sure. Like, you know, it's not like people are knocking down Rudy Giuliani's door. So
well, I don't
like,
know. You know what Henry Kissinger said was the greatest aphrodisiac, right?
What?
Power.
Oh.
Although it could be argued Giuliani doesn't have a ton of that, but you know,
yeah.
sort of.
I bet it's still washboard abs. I bet washboard abs is better than power.
Oh my God. What do you think he looks like naked now?
Oh, just like, just
do you think
like
he's
a
hairy?
Melting.
At a certain point, men lose their body hair, right? Isn't that a thing that happens to you? Like, I feel like when you cross like the 80 threshold, you know, when you're over 80, like you're not, I think you just kind of start dying and your hair falls
yeah.
out of everything, right?
Probably.
Just kind of like a mole person.
Yeah, you probably look like, you know, those like naked mole rats. You
That's
know,
what I was just
ugly.
Saying.
Yeah. yeah, you probably look like that.
Yeah.
But yeah, so I mean, like, I definitely think he went up there to hopefully, you know, get some like a blowjob from this lady or something. But as far as him, I don't think he was playing with himself. Like, I actually think, haven't you seen old guys? They do tuck their shirt in like that. Like, you
well,
know,
I haven't
got
seen
the
I haven't seen the footage.
Oh, well, they like kind of like old guys will take their pants open and then put the shirt down and then do it over. Like old guys, I don't know. I guess that's how they like fucking
Dude,
used to put their
pants
on.
Isn't it kind of crazy how old guys just don't give a fuck about their bodies anymore? And I don't know if I'm ever going to be one of those guys. I still have crazy shame, you know? But like, dude, when I was a little kid at the pool, I'd be in the locker room at our pool. I'm telling you, man, I'm like 7 years old. There'd just be like a 60-year-old man walking around fucking stark naked, dick and balls out, just like
yeah.
casual in the locker in front of children. It's just like, what the fuck? I don't know if that's like a of the era back in the 80s, or I think that kind of it's still going on. Like,
I think it, yeah, I don't know. I mean, to me, like, I know what you're saying there, but like.
Did you have those experiences, or is that just a me thing?
No, I think when I was in high school, I wasn't into like, I didn't love. I've always been I'm gonna change in the bathroom stall guy.
Yeah,
I don't need to be like, you know, like out there or anything like that.
No,
and
me neither,
you know,
dude.
I think
not
I'm,
at all.
I think I'm less weird about it now, except that so like the only place where I have to change is my kid has swimming lessons, and I've got to like go in with him.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so that's like a thing. But there, like, I go into the stall because. It's a pool and there's all these kids. That feels weird to me. I don't want to change
dude.
In front of kids.
That's
like,
what
yeah.
I'm saying.
Yeah.
Have you That's ever been in this situation? I was wondering about this. Okay, let's say you've got your son. You've got a three-year-old kid, right?
Mm-hmm.
Let's say you're walking around the mall. I don't think that's something you would ever do, but for argument's sake,
yeah.
you're walking around a
I
theme
would never
park
walk around
or a mall or some public. You're far from your car. You're far from anything. and you've got to take a shit, and you've got your kid with you, and you mm-hmm. like, you can't wait, you got to shit. Do you bring your kid into the stall with you while you're shitting and close the door, so he's just in this tiny confined space and you're just like looking at your kid just like taking a dump? Or do you leave him out in the bathroom to be just like, he's three, you can't leave a three-year-old alone in a public bathroom, he's gonna freak out, right?
Well, my answer is usually he goes with his mom.
That's not an answer. That's the most Trevor answer you could have given. I forgot who I was talking to. Yes.
I've never had that situation. I've never
been.
But
what if you did?
I would bring him in with me.
You would bring him into the stall and he would just have to be like literally in your lap while you're shitting.
Well, no, I wouldn't put him on my lap. I'd probably give him my phone to play with. Like, here, look.
For all intents and purposes, though.
Yeah. No, I'd be like, here, look, find a talk Elmo. Look at Elmo, and then I'll...
And don't
I'll
listen to daddy and try and not remember this.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. I feel like if that had happened to me, even at 3 years old, I would remember it to this day.
I saw my dad's dick once.
I think I've seen mine. Yeah. Now. How did you see your dad's dick?
I remember. I just walked into the bathroom, and he was going to the bathroom, but I remember it. It wasn't even.
What
like
was his reaction?
I'm in here.
Like fear. Like, ah!
No, I mean, he was just like, hey, I'm in here. Like, you know, kind of that. But I was
how'd
like,
you see his dick?
Because he's standing going to the bathroom.
Yeah, but how are your toilets oriented?
Oh, in my house, it was the door, like here, door swings open and the toilet's right there.
Facing the side?
Side.
So
side.
He's profile. That's a bummer of a layout.
Yeah. So yeah. I like, but I remember that. So that's
also at that
me.
Age, your head is just like dick level. So it's really, you've got just a close up shot. Yeah. It's like,
exactly.
Wow.
I don't think.
Have
I think
you seen your mom naked?
No, never have.
Never ever.
No, that is called being a good mother. Have you seen your mom naked?
I have one time.
Really?
Yeah, it was the thing. We were like out of town.
What if your story was like, I went up into the tree, I had binoculars.
I was charging my friend's admission. Oh, I was very little. I had to be like four or something like that. And it was like, I walked in a room and she was in the bathroom with the door open. And I was like, ah, and I like ran out. It was not a thing.
Traumatic.
Somebody says like the beginning of Little Nicky. Is that at all what happens in Little Nicky? I've never seen Little Nicky.
Oh, Zach, are you pretending your life story is Little Nicky again? I'm pretty sure. I think I've successfully, I don't think my kid has seen me naked at all.
Yeah, but you know what? I don't think my mom even knows that I saw her. And I don't think my dad does either. You know, dude, here's the thing. Little kids, by the time they're 10, they have seen and know every square inch of the house, dude. Like, and not only that, like, we would go to my grandfather's house, my dad's dad, and like, we knew where all, he had like Playboys and stuff, like hidden in this like one closet way up in the back in this little nook, like in another room. We like, by the time I was six, I knew where those were. You know what I mean?
Right.
I knew where, like, my dad had a ton of guns and like hidden away. I could like, I knew where the guns were. I knew how to get to them. All
that's
that
cool.
Shit. Would you say that was cool? That's cool.
That's cool. Yeah.
Is it cool?
I mean, I think if you're a little kid and you find a shitload of guns, you're like, this is fucking awesome.
One time my brother and I were in a fight. My dad had like a workshop in our basement. My brother and I, we used to get in like fucking savage fights. And we were in the workshop and my dad had his rifle rack in the workshop. And I can't remember what we were fighting about, but I picked a hammer up off my dad's tool bench and I threw it at my older brother's head. He ducked and went through the door and he pulled my dad's shotgun out of the rack. It got there, dude. It was like, we would go.
See, I wish I had brothers.
No, well, that yeah, actually, rad. Yeah. As a kid, it was awful. We never got along. As an adult, I love it. They're the best.
Yeah. Yeah. No, like with me and my sister, whenever it gets to the point where someone would like throw a punch, like I was instantly the bad guy because I was the boy.
Well, yeah, sure.
But it's your sister, you're just like, no, I'll shove you. You shove me. Like, you know,
you're
we
also
fought
older.
All... Yeah, that's right. I am 12 years older than my sister, I should point out. Like,
you're not 12 years older than her.
No, I'm joking. That'd be fun. That'd
be fucked up. I just got to that I got the joke like a little late there, yeah.
Oh my God. Someone is saying, like, someone says Newsboyz, more like Snooze Boys.
Hey, more like fuck you, you're banned. How about that? I actually banned someone this week, Trevor. I actually banned a person.
You really did?
I really did.
What for? Why?
You could use your imagination and you'd be right. Ban. Oh, people are getting worked up over the ban. People like it. I'll ban someone right now. Tell you what, did our hype train hit 500%? If it did, I'll ban somebody.
Then someone also said, I came here for news. See, we can't win.
This is news. No, dude, this guy just got a healthy dose of news. He didn't know before he came to the stream that you'd seen your dad naked. He didn't know the mathematics of what you do with your kid when you're taking a shit in public.
He didn't know that my sister and I got into physical fights.
Yeah. Fuck that, dude.
Someone says Trevor beats his sister, confirmed. I should point out my sister is my height.
Yeah, Trevor's sister could kick my ass. I don't doubt that for a second.
Yeah.
Yeah. So this is a little bit of a news, but you'll have to do the screen share because of the way this whole thing's configured. But will you do me a favor? Will you go to IGN.com? There's a story on the front page that caught my interest today. Did you ever watch Power Rangers? I know it was after our time.
No, that was kind of the first show where I was like, I think this is too little for me.
Yeah, for sure. But you're aware of Power Rangers.
Oh, right? Absolutely.
You don't have to be intimately familiar with it.
No, I know. I know them.
All right. They're rebooting Power Rangers, or maybe it's still going. Maybe they rebooted it a long time ago. But the main red Power Ranger, the star of Power Rangers, is like back reprising his role. But pull it up. Let's take a look at him. It's fucking funny.
Oh, there's an ad.
All right, that's all right. Oh my God, can you can we full screen that video? I don't think anyone else on the internet thought this was hilarious, but I was fucking dying.
Okay. Oh wait, you know, I'm gonna stop.
Look at him.
How late is it?
Look at him, dude.
Hold on.
You gotta look at the before picture. Actually, pull that guy's before photo up so we can get a sense of him.
Well, what is his name? How do I pull up?
Scroll down. His name's in the article.
Hold on.
Oh my God, dude.
What is his name? Jason Lee Scott.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's see this dude. Dude, how happy is he? He must be psyched.
Oh, he's stoked.
All right, here we go. Wait a minute. Okay, I gotta share again. Computer sound on. All right, here we go.
So this is his before. Okay, there it is. That's a good one with the red checkered situation there. Hang on, let me pull him more. Let me do a little.
He's a dreamboat.
Oh, he's a stud. He's a stud muffin. He's so hot. Yeah. And he's got that 90s, that late 80s, early 90s. I know that was shot in like the late 90s, but remember back then, like guys with like kind of puffy faces were hot? I guess Miles Teller kind of has that sort of a face.
Yeah.
That like Elvis Presley puff face.
They liked people with no discernible jawline.
Yeah. Moon face, I believe, is how they would describe it. Yeah. Look at this guy. Play this fucking trailer. Turn the audio on. Right. Oh my God. Don't even give a fuck. It's like, yeah, we'll just get a skinny guy to be the fucking Power Ranger when you change. It's fine. It's fine.
He's like, it's pancake time. That's his like new catchphrase.
Oh my God. Yeah, he's happy.
Yeah. He's, it's like, you ever see those old 1941 Batman movies?
Not the Adam West ones?
No, before. So basically in the 40s, they made a bunch of Batman films.
I'm not familiar with these.
Oh, they're hilarious.
Intentionally, obviously.
No, they're trying to be like regular. But it's funny because like Batman it's back in those days when like everybody just looked like a barrel.
Uh-huh.
You know, like all those, like even like, you know, like Hollywood tough guys just look like a big like barrel kind of. So Batman
that was like very much part of it. Like where from the profile, they would kind of have a gut, but it wasn't like weak. It was just like their stomach would kind of like come out and go down. Right. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah. You could like to be a tough guy back then. It was like, oh, we can hit him with a board and he won't feel it. Like that was sort of, you know, I'm trying to find. Yeah. So Batman is like this big fat guy. Here, let me. This is the 1941. You should look these up. They're really kind of cool.
I do love me some Batman. Oh my God, it's kind of creepy.
Show Batman. Yeah, he's just like a big dude.
Bat. So Batman in this Batman movie.
Well, there he was. Anyway.
Yeah.
But you gotta, he looks like he's like that dude from The Honeymooners, basically.
Yeah.
Like,
Oh, this is a good question. So Stezzy Kim says, how come Trevor doesn't say Batman like he says Discman?
Well, that's a good question. I don't know, because I guess Batman just sounds like Batman. The only
because
the other one
Batman.
But I always say the other one I do is Spider-Man. I always say Spider-Man.
As a joke.
It might have started as a joke, but I just say Spider-Man now a lot.
Yeah.
Yes, it's fake accent.
Yeah.
It's the other
Quibi has been canceled. All right. So Killer CBH, yes. I mean, do you have any opinion on Quibi being canceled?
You know, that was, I mean, Quibi, I mean, so the thing about Quibi, like, and I don't take joy in the fact that Quibi's gone because, you know, it's another place where people can do comedy shows. That's good. You know, I think a lot of people had shows that they wanted to do there and that's gone. So that's sad. But it was, to me, it was like, they were like, what we're going to do is we're going to make 10 minute episodes. And this is, I've always hated this idea. Like, it's something that I feel like they've been trying since the internet started. You know, that's what they were like, a web series, like webisodes, like that. It's never worked. It's never caught on. Like, it's just like.
But what about Adult Swim? It worked with Adult Swim. It was wildly successful.
That's an outlier. That's the only place where that works, you know, because everything else, like, you know, if you look at. If you look at what people watch on Netflix, they just want to watch regular shows. They just like the Netflix format.
Yeah.
And then also see, what's it called? Fucking Quibi was like, and you can't watch it on your TV. You've got to watch it on your phone.
Well, that to me is where the whole thing just went fucking stupid. Yeah.
Yeah.
And we did our third season, I think. We had to do 10-minute episodes, but that was a mandate from the network, and we were fucking apoplectic about that, remember?
They got mad at us because I said it was a stupid idea on the phone call. Remember that?
No, but I believe that.
Yeah, I said that's a dumb idea. You're just trying to be like Adult Swim, but the thing is, Adult Swim has worked on they've built up a library over years. You're trying to do it with just us, like you, it's not going to work. And they were like, not happy.
Yeah,
about,
because they'd had meetings, and it was somebody in that phone call. It was their idea. And this was their big move, and
they had some PR douche who was like, "I got it. We'll rip off Adult Swim."
But it fucking sucked, man. It sucked for us.
Yeah.
Anyway. So what else happened in the news this week? Talk about the guy who got caught jerking off on Zoom. Well, Jeffrey Toobin, this is a big one, right? You know about this.
Fantastic. I love that.
And I love Jeffrey Toobin, man. I read The Run of His Life. I read A Vast Conspiracy. I mean, the guy's amazing. He's a great writer.
Never heard of him.
Are you kidding?
No.
Oh. He's just like a very smart political journalist. He wrote great books. But So he, you know, he's on staff at the New Yorker. This is for the two of you in this stream that don't know about this story. But they were doing, here's what I think is bizarre. They were doing a mock debate. Like before the third presidential debate, they were doing a mock debate where like this person's Trump and this person's Biden and this person is like undecided and this person is the justice, the court. And he was representing the courts actually, which is like, what's the purpose of this? They weren't doing it in public. It wasn't for like public consumption. Like why?
Honestly, if I got that assignment, I'd probably just be jerking it.
Yeah. Yeah. No. I feel like it's so embarrassing. This is like the most embarrassing thing. So anyway, in the middle of it, they took a 10-minute break, but they left the Zoom going, and then I guess they said he lowered his camera, whatever that means, and then started jerking off. So
he probably did one of these deals. Like he was like,
and then like aiming it right at his crotch. I mean,
yeah. The funniest thing about that to me is like, I mean, I didn't know much about the guy, but I know he's successful. And it's a very competitive field that he was successful in. Mm-hmm. You know, literary world, political world, you know, New York, like, you know, like, so like his life, he was just, you know, playing the politics right. And he was beating and overachieving at every single step along the way.
Crushing it. Very well respected.
And then this is all he's ever going to be known for.
Well, no. He'll be known for some other stuff, but
no, you can't come back from this. It's like that old Irish joke. You know, the guy.
I've locked my wife and her friends out. I have to go open the door. Sorry, man. Hang on.
No worries. You don't want to like just wait until we're going to be done by 10, right? So yeah, someone says good writer. He was, oh man, chat's going too fast. Mitch McConnell's hands. Yeah, Mitch McConnell's hands. That looks gross, right? That's just another thing. Everybody's too fucking old in our government, because he's got that. He probably just fell down the stairs because both of his hands were messed up. His face is all fucked up. He looked like the Emperor in that last Star Wars movie when he's like on the wall kind of thing.
What are you talking about?
Fucking what's his name? Mitch McConnell with all his fucked up.
Oh,
hands.
His hand. Do you see his
hand? Yeah. That's what we're talking about.
Oh,
yeah.
God, dude.
Yeah, he looked like. Did you see the last Star Wars movie?
No.
Where they got the Emperor hooked up and all his fingers have fallen off and he's like trying to get a new body, like Krang, and then that's what he looked like. But that's the thing. He's like 78 years old. We gotta have a fucking cutoff in like government. Like, you know, 70, you're done. Like, because like. He's got that thing. Like old people, they fall down and then everything, you know, their skin's like paper. So they're like everything, their hands get black and everything. Yeah.
Dude, Mitch McConnell. It's fucking rotting from the inside out, man. Ugh. It's like Mike Pence goes on. He's got his eyes bleeding from the inside. He's got flies landing on him. Mitch, I mean, they're just like, they're zombie people. It's fucking.
Let's just get some
wretched
60-year-old people in government.
Yeah,
60.
Right?
That's all that's not even, that's still pretty old. It's very old.
Term limits. It's funny. Did you see? I was looking at the GOP was posting like Trump's second term agenda. And they were like, one of the things was instituting term limits on Congress. So I was like, fucking, if that's something you wanted to do, why didn't you do that when you had control of the fucking House and you were president? Like, what have you been doing?
Yeah.
Let's do it.
I don't think you'll really get a big
blowback.
Here's
an idea that I think they should do is like, why don't you set these sorts of things, but say they don't kick in for another 20 years. That way, nobody working right now is going to get fucked. No one's going to get fired from their deal. But in 20 years, we're going to start instituting term limits. You know, then everyone can agree it's the good for the country. Blah 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 blah. Anyway.
Yeah, I agree. Someone says, Trevor, do you like sovereign citizen theory? No, my uncle was really into that. It sounds crazy to me. It's the idea that it's basically, oh God, I'm going to do a horrible job at explaining it. I looked into this years ago. It's that when you're born, the government uses your existence to start a small loan company. And so they can borrow money based on the number of citizens they have. You know, because we have X amount of people that are going to be able to do X amount of hours of work throughout their lifetime.
This is a theory or this is real?
I don't know. I'm just going into the sovereign citizen theory, but this is, they say this is real. And so there's supposedly a corporation that is in your name. And tell me if I'm getting this wrong, whoever knows about this thing. And so the sovereign citizen theory is that you can reclaim the business that has been made in your name. And then you are kind of outside.
This isn't real. They don't make a business in your name. It's not real.
Well, so this is a lot of people get into, a lot of militia people get into this. Like I think those guys in Montana that had that compound like about 10 years ago, that was their big thing, was the sovereign citizen theory. So that's it's a fringe kind of thing. Someone said people were asking for the Irish joke.
The Irish joke? What is that?
Well, it's like I was saying, like with this Jeffrey Toobin. It's like that old. You've heard that old Irish joke. I'll try to tell it fast. A guy is walking through town, goes to like a pub, sees an old man at the end of the bar. They talk or whatever, And yeah, someone's got it right there. But he goes, well, you know, what's your name? And the guy takes a drink and he's like, you see that bridge you walked over to get here? Yeah, that one.
Yeah.
I'll let me go fast just for people.
Power through that bad boy.
Yeah. You see that bridge that came here? I took every stone, built that bridge. I chopped the wood myself. Do you think they call me Seamus the Bridge Maker? No. And he's like, you see that pier? I'm the one that made that pier. I went out there and I stuck the boards into the mud and I'm the one that like fought against the currents and I made that. You think they call me Ishmael the pier builder? No. But you fuck one goat.
Yeah. Wait a minute. I told this story on my collective soul stream, but I'm going to tell it again here because the Newsboys stories are always the ones that make it to the YouTube. But have I told you the story about when I was in Fiji and so you know, I'm shooting that show Wrecked in Fiji and my wife comes out and she's staying with me for a couple weeks. And, you know, I'm a giant fan of that show Survivor, right? Like, mm-hmm. I'm big, big fan of it. Yeah. And they were shooting Survivor in Fiji at the same time. In fact, some of the Survivor crew, like one guy worked on our show also. And I was talking to him on set. And I was like, dude, I fucking love Survivor. That's so cool that it's close by. Like, he was like, oh, dude, you should totally come over and like check it out. And I was like, all right. Yes. So on a day off, Sarah and I like chartered a boat and we like, so Survivor has like their own island that they use. And there's like a resort on the island. They have the whole resort. It's kind of like a dream life. It's like they're the same crew of like 300 people and they just go from country to country to country to country together. They've been doing it for like 20 years. They've had like people married, had kids from the show. They're just all, it's like a traveling circus.
The family.
It seems like the perfect life. Anyway, everyone's super cool. They like showed us around. We met Jeff, the host, and like watched a competition while they were taping. It was super rad. And we go to the, by the way, I see the comments. Everyone's talking about the social security number is a bank account. That's fascinating. And I actually believe it. So we go to the art tent where all the art department's making all the props. And have I told you this story? They're making all their props. And we're like in the workshop and it's really cool. And this closet door kind of is ajar and I see someone like pull something out of it and there's all these like newspaper clippings taped to the closet door and on this one newspaper clipping it's a photo it's all in an African language that like we can't read but there's a big photograph of a crowd of people in a village like in a big semicircle and in the middle of the semicircle is a man and he's fucking a goat. And it's in the paper with an article. And I'm like, what the fuck is going on with the article, dude?
But to be fair, I think if you do it anywhere, it would get in the paper.
Well,
if you got, if wait, you got a big
wait till you hear what the fuck the article is, right? So they're like, yeah. So we were shooting in, and I don't remember for the life of me what African country they were shooting in. But they're like, we're shooting in this country. And it was a big deal that we were there. So, you know, in the local paper, they had a big, on the other side of this, it was like a two-pager thing. This page was this big full-page ad about us being in town. And it was like, so we got the paper to look at our shit. So it was like, Survivor's here, everyone be nice to them, they're gonna bring all this money, blah, blah, blah. But on the other side is this guy fucking a goat. So we were like, you know, we got somebody on our crew that could speak the language. We're like, what is the story? What is happening? He's like, oh, this man is, I'm not going to do the accent. That's terrible. Because he's like, well, why not? He's like, this man is thief. This man is thief. And they're like, this man is a thief?
He goes, he stole that goat's heart.
This man is a thief. He got fucking, he got caught shoplifting. And the judge of this town, like the local authority was like, your punishment is that you have to fuck a goat in front of the whole town. And we're going to put
hell
it in the
yeah.
newspaper. And hell, that's what it was. Yeah. It was like shaming him. But that fucking a goat. He had
dude,
to. Is that the craziest
yeah.
shit you ever heard in your life?
Dude, I bet they have such a low crime rate.
Here's like the thing. That guy started stealing every fucking day. He just wouldn't stop stealing. They're like, all right, get the goats out of here. What the fuck?
Dude, that judge is intense. Yeah. They're like, do you want to put him in the jail? He's like, yeah. No way. No way. Go with me on this.
Oh my God.
Oh man, the poor goat. How do they, I mean, unless they're like, this goat loves this shit. Like, this goat's all about it. He's all about that life. And,
Well, remember Vice article? Remember that Vice article from 20 years ago about the shaved gorilla?
Yeah,
let's not even go there. It's too much.
Yeah, that's a very dark article. Yeah, but people should look it up. It's very good.
Yeah.
Wow, that's crazy. Like, I do hope that the goat was into it.
Oh, I'm sure it was. I mean, come on. That's like the highest honor that a goat could ever have, being fucked by a human.
It would be like an alien coming down and being like, we have chosen you to breed with us. You know, if you're like, oh, okay, I guess you're smarter, so I guess this makes sense. Like, that's what it would be like. The goat would be like, really? They think I'm hot?
Yeah.
Like, he probably is like walking back to the other goats being like,
guess what? Yeah. Plus, a human dick probably feels really good to a goat because it's like soft and smooth. There's a goat dick is probably like barbed and, you know.
Do you think all animals like the same things that humans do? Like, do you think they want soft or smooth?
I think goats want goat dicks. I don't think
they probably want a craggly, scabby dick.
They're like, oh, that dick was so barbed and so pokey. It was awesome.
Yeah.
Although, don't dolphins, isn't it? I mean, it's not a rumor, right? Dolphins have fucked with humans and dolphins have fucked. For
pleasure. Yeah, no, dolphins rape people. They're one of the only animals
Is that true?
Absolutely true. Yeah. Dolphins are.
Can you find an article?
Yeah. You know, there was a dolphin in France a couple years ago that they had to like get out to sea because it kept trying to rape people.
Was a serial rapist.
Yeah, it was like, you know, it was because people like tourists were going up to it and taking photos because they're like, this dolphin's really nice. And then he's like, like, you know, and they're like, oh, we got to get rid of this dolphin. Like, you know, and so like it was a big enough problem that they had to go corral this dolphin and like be like, get the fuck out of here.
I want to see a Jaws movie, but it's about a dolphin that's fucking raping people.
No, that's the weird thing. Dolphins are like, you know, they're so smart. They're also one of the only other animals that commit suicide.
Right. Yeah. That's dark.
It's weird that intelligent is linked to rape and suicide. It's like, is it good to be intelligent? Probably not. It's probably good to be like a dumb goat.
Somebody says, dolphins have prehensile penises. I don't know what that word means. What does
prehensile mean? A knuckle. They have a joint.
Oh. Ugh. That's kind of... like Geiger.
Yeah. You know,
it's kind of revolting. Somebody says, it's true. Dolphins are trash. They are trash, guys. That's true.
I'm not a huge fan of animals.
Somebody says, you like to watch Blackfish, but you turned it off before the ending. You're in it.
Yeah.
The Cove is like your favorite movie.
No, but you know what? Like, I do fucking, I hate fucking sharks.
You hate sharks?
Yeah. And like when people are like, oh, you know, there's so many sharks or, you know, we're like, you know, like it's, you know, if we don't do this, if we don't turn this around, we might not have sharks in a couple hundred years. I'm like, who the fuck cares? Like, you know, like what do we fucking need sharks for? They're fucking assholes. And also it's like, don't they eat the same fish we do?
I have no idea.
Like, who cares if we kill? They're also saying there's not enough fish in the water now. But if you kill all the sharks, there'd be a lot more fish. I'm sure there's something I'm not thinking
about.
Yeah,
I'm sure that there is. Yeah. You know, Trevor, do you believe Avril Lavigne was replaced by a lookalike in 2004 after dying of an OD?
I have never heard that. I've heard that with I've heard a similar rumor of that with Miley Cyrus.
JonBenet Ramsey.
Mm-hmm. But I've never heard it with Avril Lavigne. Yeah. I'd buy it. I saw Avril Lavigne once at the W. That's all I got. It wasn't a good
story. Did you
say
anything?
No.
Have you ever just spotted a celebrity and then it led to an interaction?
The only celebrity I've ever seen and gotten like kind of starstruck was Sam and I saw Dave Grohl in a bathroom once, which is pretty cool.
That's cool.
And like we both stopped because
I bet you could say hi to Dave Grohl. I bet he'd be like, oh, cool, guys.
Well, Sam and I, we didn't say anything, but we walked in and Dave Grohl was walking out. We both just like looked dumb and we were like, oh, like that. And then Dave Grohl goes, points at both of us and goes, yeah. And like kept going like that.
That's his move, right?
But it's also, it's like people who are Sam and my age.
There's a 100% chance you know who he is and you're a fan.
Yeah. yeah. we were, you know, 12 years old when Nirvana came out, right. like, you know, 11 years old, like every single person he sees in that age group must just go, oh,
yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. So, I mean, yeah.
Even though, like, I find his music just insufferable post 2004, but yeah, what are you going to do? I couldn't help myself. I had to say that. Why do I have to?
Such a contrarian. Such a contrarian. Everyone loves Dave Grohl. He's the
Tom
Hanks.
I love Nirvana. Love Nirvana. But dude, yeah. watching his Muscle Shoals show, whatever that fucking show where he goes on tour.
I love that. Ugh. I love that show.
It's cool because he meets fun, interesting people like Ian MacKaye. But then at the end of every episode, you have to listen to a Dave Grohl song, and it's just like,
yeah. But didn't you like he did the whole thing? He did the whole thing on DC. Didn't you like that?
Yeah, I liked seeing Ian MacKaye. I could have done a little less fucking Zach being elitist. Yeah. Fuck you, dude.
Yep. Way to be a gatekeeper.
Yeah, whatever. I'm right, though. That's the problem.
So the guy that I had an interaction, not really an interaction with, but when we were, it was at Pianos when we were doing what? our Whitest Kid show in Pianos in the mid 2000s. I was outside smoking a cigarette, and at that time, my favorite thing in the world was this documentary called Dope Sick Love. That used to be on HBO.
That's a fucking dark doc, dude.
And I watched it, I don't know why, I watched it all the time. And it was just these couples who were like addicted to heroin together, and it just followed them. And it just like, it was just kept getting worse. Like there's this really like heart-wrenching scene where they like drop their, you know, heroin, they can't find it, they're going back on the ground looking for it and everything. And it was just like, but there's this one guy, Sebastian, and he had a girlfriend, and what they do is they go on Craigslist and he would let guys blow him and he would get money.
Why does that make me laugh? You're like, he would let guys blow him, and I'm like, he would. Why am I laughing at that?
Well, it's like in the last Buckerson and Myers, how like Sam was like, dicks aren't funny. Like, I'm an adult.
Yeah,
like
he's
that.
Like, I'm a grown up. I don't care if I drink out of a dick glass. I'm like, dude, what kind of a grown up is like, oh, someone wrote their dick? I don't care. I'm mature enough to drink this.
I'm like, I'm 40 years old. I still laugh my ass off anytime a dick comes up in conversation. But so, yeah, so this guy, he would go to Craigslist and he would let people blow him and they'd give him money. And I remember that was like crazy to me because it was counterintuitive. Like, I was like, wait, he gets paid for people blowing him? Like, you know, like, and I was like, wow, Craigslist is crazy. So he would let people blow him, and then he would get enough money to go get heroin. Then his girlfriend, she'd be waiting outside while dudes were blowing him. And then she'd be like, okay, we can go get our heroin. They lost their heroin. Anyway, his name was Sebastian. Mm. And one night I was at Pianos, I was smoking a cigarette, and I saw Sebastian on a bicycle, like riding up that street. And I was like, oh, because I watch this thing all the time. And I just blurted out, Sebastian, like that. And he stopped and he turned around like that. And then I was like, oh, what the fuck do I do now? Like, I can't be like, huge fan.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
You know,
love
like
your work.
You know.
Keep it up. Don't stop. Do not stop.
Yeah. So he turned around like, who said that? I was like, oh, I got nowhere to go with this. So I just like went back inside like that. But that was the only involuntary like kind of interaction I forced with a celebrity.
Whoa, whoa. No. Remember when you were at the Disney store in Times Square?
Toys R Us. Yeah, yeah.
Oh, was it Toys R Us?
Yeah. I was at Toys R Us. And who's the guy? What's his name?
Well, you tell the story and then I'll say, okay. I know who it was.
Oh, I know what his name is now. Okay. I'll tell it. So I'm at a Toys R Us and Sam and I went, and it was like, you know, it was like a midnight thing. And we were like up around there, and we went to see like, cause they were having like all these new Star Wars products.
You guys are so fucking lame, dude.
For the movie, yeah. We're like, oh, let's go see.
You went to the midnight thing to look at Star Wars products?
In our defense, I don't think we went all the way up there to do that. I think we were there and we saw a line and that's what was happening.
You're like, hey, while we're here, let's go look at the new Star Wars products. Fucking losers, dude.
So we went in. And I know that we're drunk. We're very drunk because it was like...
That actually makes it better.
Yeah, we're like walking around. We're just looking at toys. That's like all toys. Like it's not like... I don't know what we... We're like... So we're like... And there's a guy next to me that I recognize. And I'm drunk. And I'm like, hey, I know you. Like, and he's like... No, you don't. I'm like, yeah, dude, you go to my school. And
yeah, dude, you go to my school. You're just and loud like, and fucking aggressive.
Yeah, he's like, I don't go to your school. I'm like, yeah, SBA.
You're telling him what school he goes to.
You go to SBA? And he's like, no. And he leaves like that. And then, do you want to take the story from there?
There's nowhere to take it. It was Seth Green.
No, the story, the next night, he's on Letterman.
Oh, really?
Yeah, and we're all hanging out in the dorm room, and Seth Green comes out. I'm like, that's the guy from fucking Toys R Us, like that. And he sits down on Letterman, and Letterman's like, so do people recognize you a lot? He's like, yeah, drunk people tell me that they think I go to school with them.
he said that?
Yeah, so it was like the night after. Like, he was like,
get the fuck out of here. Do you think we could find that Letterman and see him saying that?
Probably. I don't know if he says drunk, but he was like, yeah, people will always tell me that they think they go to school with me or something like that. Yeah. If you look up Seth Green on Letterman in like the early 2000s.
That's so funny.
But I was that guy.
Yeah, you do. You go to my school.
Hey, because Seth Green's like not a guy that you'd be like, oh, maybe you would, but I wasn't like a guy that was like, oh, because the only thing I would have known him from was like the Austin Powers movie.
Yeah.
You know, that. So I was like, oh.
Yeah. I would have recognized him from Austin Powers probably. And he had done Can't Hardly Wait, which was a movie that I found was kind of oddly good. Was he there? And he's a big nerd, right? So he was there to see the Star Wars products, just like you guys were, obviously.
Yeah. No, but see, then after that, didn't he do a whole show that was just Star Wars toys?
I think Robot Chicken was like, somehow. I've never watched Robot Chicken, but.
Well, he was like serious. He was like a collector going through and like, you know, he had a lot of shit. Like, you know, he was like grabbing.
Yeah.
But yeah.
Yeah. Somebody says, but I don't know that. Yeah, I guess he was in that. Was he in that? What was the name of that fucking movie with like Whoopi Goldberg and they're all Rat Race? Was he in Rat Race? I think he was.
I don't know.
Anyway, whatever. It doesn't matter.
I don't know. What else we got news wise? So did Amy Coney Barrett, did she get through?
Yeah, she got confirmed, right?
She's a judge now.
Or she passed through the congressional hearing, so that's done.
So she's a judge.
I think she's not, but I think she's going to be. It's like pretty much done.
Okay. All right. So that's
Here's a good one. OxyContin, the company, is it Pfizer? I wish it was Pfizer.
It's not Pfizer.
It was?
It's a family. It's not Pfizer. It's a family. It's a family that made this whole OxyContin thing.
So they pled guilty in federal court to something, and I guess they got hit for like over $1 billion. That's pretty dope.
Wow. Well, that's good. I mean,
I wonder where that money goes.
Probably, hopefully, to all the families of the people that have died, because it's like they just flooded this country with shitty.
Oh shit! You know what, guys? Hang on. You're gonna lose us for a second here, chat. I'm gonna do a. I'm gonna do a thing here so that we can do our alert box. There it is. We should have our alert box going. People took the time to make this alert box, and I've been.
Do you have to do like thank yous?
I should be doing some thank yous. Yeah. Why don't I knock out a couple of these? I don't like to let it go too long, and then we have to do all the thank yous in one big go. It's kind of a bummer. Ah, hang on, guys. There it is. Now we're back. All right, give me a second. Find another news story while I'm doing these thank yous.
Well, we could talk about the debate. The debate that was the big thing that happened.
I didn't really watch it, man. I can't. It's too stressful for me now. I just get too wound up.
I watched it.
You did?
Yeah. I thought they both did well.
You thought they both did well?
Yeah, I was like. Because in the first one, I thought Trump did horrible.
Uh-huh.
Like he's just he was annoying and he's just like yelling over people. And like Biden did fine because he wasn't Trump.
Right.
You know, like he wasn't the annoying guy, but like you couldn't really hear him anyway. So this one, it was like they at least, you know, they would talk and then like you'd hear the other one. It was at least like going back and forth. And so I think they both did better than they. I don't think it's going to change anything in any direction because like who doesn't know who they're voting for at this point?
If there's anyone in this chat that's undecided, we could try and pull somebody in. But I actually know because somebody's going to just pretend.
I would love to talk to an undecided person.
I would, although we have this Discord problem where I don't think you can hear them. They can hear you, kind of an issue. Remember, didn't we have that issue last time? We've got technical bullshit. Hang on, let me do a couple thank yous real fast. Ask Eagles. I love people's names, dude. Ask Eagles, thanks for the Prime sub. Twerking, thank you for gifting, you fucking angel. Twerking is like the greatest. Pop likes it hot. Thank you for donating, stupid kid. Thanks, buddy. Oh, wait, I'm getting into the past. Dude, hang on. Foxy Tay, thank you. Calvin CB GBC, I appreciate it. Crippled Panda, thanks, buddy. Zach Jock Mac, I feel like I might be looking at an antiquated list here.
Oh, really?
It's possible. I'm so bad at all this shit. Yeah, I think I gotta have some sort of an issue. I don't know why this is doing this. I'm gonna figure it out. I'll tag it up in a minute.
This is our penultimate Newsboyz episode before the election.
Wait a minute. Oh, penultimate. Yeah, that's right. Holy shit. Wait, what day is the election?
Tuesday. Not this Tuesday, but a week from Tuesday.
Wow.
Holy shit, next Friday.
Whipboy 79. Thanks, buddy.
Next Friday will be our very last. Oh, someone says three. Is there 3 weeks? No, there can't
be.
No.
It's 12 days. I know that.
Yeah. So this will be, next week will be our last one as we sail into the night of uncertainty. And are we going to do you want to do a election night Newsboyz?
I'm going to a friend's house for the election night. I'm doing a whole thing over there. I'm not going to be around.
Okay.
Yeah, I would like to, but I also, like, dude, I will be a fucking ball of nerves. It'll get ugly if shit goes south.
Maybe I'll do one, but I don't know how to run the Twitch. I've never done the Twitch.
Well, you know what?
Myself.
I bet you could get Sam to do it, and he could run it. He could do the thing.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, or Griffin. I'm sure you could get somebody to do it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, maybe I'll do one for election night.
Yeah, cool.
I'll do, but I still want it to be
I'll call in.
It'll just be a half Newsboyz. Yeah, because you're going to be super stressed, so we'll just check in with you and see how you're doing.
Yeah, you can call in and see how my mental health is doing.
Okay.
Dude, yeah. It was just too brutal last time.
We'll do a very special Newsboyz. Newsboy.
Newsboy. That's right.
Someone in the chat on the Tuesday of the election, and we will have a special correspondent, Zach Kreger.
Yeah.
Are you mentally prepared for Trump to win?
No.
Really?
I mean, I don't know if I can be. I honestly feel like 4 more years of this is just, it's just going to be an unmitigated disaster.
Wouldn't you think that was the healthiest thing to try to prep yourself for?
How do you do that? How do you prep?
Oh.
You don't give a shit. I kind of envy.
I give a shit.
I know that you technically give a shit, but I know that really you don't, like. By the way, it's good. It's a good thing. Like, you're not like me. You can, like, detach yourself and recognize, like, I'm powerless over this. Like, there's nothing, mm-hmm. What am I going to do? I mean,
right.
It's a good thing. It's a good thing. You've got more zen in that department than I do.
Someone said he voted, bro. That's right.
Yeah, good.
I voted.
Yeah, that's awesome. I'm glad you did.
And I left everything else blank because I didn't know what to do.
Did you really?
Yeah. I mean, I started doing it. Well, what happened was, I started marking them because I would read it and I was like, oh yeah, that seems like bullshit. And I'd like do that. And then I was talking to my wife and I was like, so I voted this on this one. She's like, why would you vote that on that one? I was like, oh, is that bad? Like, and she was like, you don't know what you're doing.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, some of them are deceptive and like, it seems like, yeah. 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 Yeah.
You know the one that confused me? I think we talked about this, right? The Uber one.
I don't even pretend to really understand. I voted for them to make it so that the Uber drivers have to be treated like employees, because I do think it's kind of a predatory system right now where like they get right. to call everyone like contractors and then they don't have to pay insurance or all kinds of benefits and all that shit. I think that's bullshit because
But here's the other thing.
You can't all these jobs and then call everyone contractors. Like, you're obliterating jobs. Let's treat people right.
Right.
But I got people messaged me, and like a ton of people, like, you voted to send Uber out of California. I hope you're happy. Personally, I don't give a fuck if Uber leaves California. Fuck.
You don't use Uber? See, that's the thing is because I was like,
I use Lyft, but whatever. But like,
I don't use Lyft because they're too talky.
It's the same drivers.
No, you can put, there's a thing on Uber. You can be like, don't talk to me.
Yeah.
That's pretty cool. Yeah. But But there's a yeah, but that's what I, that was my conflicted thing. It's like, you know, look, I want everyone to make as much money as they can, you know, like, yeah, you know, I would like minimum wage to be higher and everything like that. But at the same time, if Uber's like, if this goes through, we're not going to give Uber to California. I need that. That's why I don't have DUIs. Like, right.
But you would get taxis. It's not like you wouldn't be able to get transportation. And like Lyft would fill the void. Like they're not going to leave California. There's too much money to
do,
dude.
But no. Oh, so wait, is Lyft's not leaving too? It would just be Uber.
Neither of them are really going to leave. They're not. It's not going to work that way.
Someone says taxis are garbage, and that's absolutely true. Taxis are horrible. Like I remember, you know, before Uber in LA. And I would have to call 5 taxis to get one to show up.
Yeah.
You know, like it is. And that's the thing.
It's,
like,
it's terrible.
And when Uber was coming, like, and taxi drivers didn't give a fuck. And they were just had, like terrible service for decades.
Yeah.
You know? And so then when Uber was coming and they were all fucking losing their jobs, they were like, it's killing the taxi drivers. And then we were like, everyone hates you. Like, you.
Yeah.
Fucking terrible forever. Like,
also,
you know.
Yellow Cab, why don't you just invest in an app and compete, dude? Just like, why don't you do what they're doing? Like, they built a better mousetrap. No one's stopping you from like integrating that in your fucking Yellow Cab. Just put it on your phone.
Yeah. So I hope you're happy, Zach. That's what you voted for.
I don't give a fuck. I don't know. Dude, have you barfed in a taxi cab?
No, I'm not a big barfer.
Oh, no?
No.
Yeah.
Have you?
I barfed in a cab on the way home from our rap party for Miss March. We were at that house,
really?
Remember? I got so fucked up. And it was one of those things where it was like in the backseat of a yellow cab on the way home. And I was like, I knew I was going to throw up, but I was like, just get home. Like, just get, like, if I can just keep it in and like,
right,
get me to the apartment building. And it was one of those, I'm embarrassed of this, but like, we were like pulling up to the building and I just couldn't hold it anymore. And I lay down in the seat. And I just quietly, like silently, was just like, all of it into the footwell. And then I was like, bye. Left. Fucking poor guy.
Somebody says you weren't even drunk. It was the movie.
Well, that's fair. Yeah,
that's
it was probably
a
combination.
I like that. You are. How do we make it so he can never get banned for life? That's a funny
you're protected
joke.
For life.
You're protected for life.
It is fucked up. It is fucked up what I did. I know. I feel bad about it.
So you didn't tell him?
No.
No. You know, I would say I'm not a big barfer, but there was a period right before I quit smoking and went to like just nicotine lozenges and vaping and stuff like that. I grew up in tobacco country, like, you know, I smoked so much fucking cigarettes. And it got to the point when we were editing Miss March, you know, where every time I would smoke a cigarette, within the first cigarette, I would vomit.
What?
Yeah. And then I would just like
during the day too?
Yeah. I just got to something was going on where I was like every time I'd smoke a cigarette I'd throw up and then I'd be fine. It was just like breaking the seal or something like that.
That was like very concerning.
Oh yeah. This is why I quit smoking. But it got to the point where it was sort of normal to me for a while. So like we'd be at like the Dresden or something, and like I remember one night me and Monty and you were there, and I was like, hey, let's go out and smoke a cigarette. And you go outside, and I'm smoking a cigarette, and I'm like, oh, hold on. And I vomited into a plant and then, like, went back to smoking and talking. He was like, are you okay? I'm like, oh, yeah, that just fucking happens now, like that. And he was like, what the fuck? Like, and that's why I had to, like, quit smoking.
It's funny. When we were shooting Wrecked in Puerto Rico, our first season, there was a director, and at one of our, like, late-night revelry things, we're, like, at some fancy hotel, and he was, like, drunk and talking to everyone, and he like did exactly what you did. It was like he's like holding court. He's like, yeah, into a plant, and there's like, I know, and everyone was like, no, dude, you can't like pretend that didn't happen. He's like, no, it's fine. It was like, no, that's not fine. You fucking freak.
That's where I was.
Yeah,
that was exactly where I was at.
Yeah. One of my buddies in Oakland, man, we would go bar hopping, and he would like get so trashed at a bar. We would walk from one, as we're walking to the next, he wouldn't stop walking. He would just be like walking outside, just be like, and then just like walk right into the next bar and like order another tequila. It was just like, dude, fucking amazing.
That's great.
Yeah. Yeah, man. Great, great,
hard,
great,
hard hitting news tonight.
Yeah.
Yeah. You know, we've been over 1,000 for most of this show. Yeah. We're doing,
because we are delivering the news. If anyone in chat is like, I can't believe I came here for the news, I just want to remind you that you are getting news. You actually are.
We interlace it.
Yeah.
With colorful tales from life.
Yeah.
That is the format. It's doing great. This is the fastest growing show on the network. I believe it's the most consistent with holding its audience.
I think that's actually not even up for dispute.
Yeah. And again, we really appreciate it in all the other shows that you go in there and talk about how this is the superior show. It really just brings a smile to our face.
It's good. Keep it up. Don't stop. We couldn't do it without you guys and all your support. Somebody says, tell a story about Whitest Kids production. Dude.
Do you want to tell Timmy's banana story?
There's so many, and yet none spring to mind. I don't know.
Yeah, I mean, it's like...
It was a blur, dude.
Well, it was also like, it's not like, you know, you almost need to have... you need to hear something that triggers a memory.
The thing about shooting Whitest Kids, and I feel like this is actually the case for shooting any TV show or movie, is like, you're in such a race against the sun or the clock, you know? Like, for Whitest Kids, one day we had to shoot 17 pages in one day. Yep. And that's not in one location. That's 17 pages. That was probably 6 sketches. We are like sprinting. We shot the whole show in a panic.
And for people who don't know a production, that is, I mean, I tell that to this day. Like, when we have like a bad a day schedule, I'm like, well, on Whitest Kids, we did 17 pages one day. And people are like, get the fuck out of here. Like, you know, if you've got a 11 page day, people are like, how, we're not going to fucking make our day, kind of thing. Like, you know, so.
That's why all of our shit looks like garbage.
Yeah.
know, honestly, it's like, sometimes I look at our production design and I'm like, it's a blank wall. It's like someone sitting in front of a blank wall with the same plant that's in every other sketch. And I'm like, I'm embarrassed that this is what we have. But like, we had no time, dude. We had no time at all.
Oh, you know what? I just got a random story that I want to hear. You tell.
Sure.
Tell this. This is not a great story. I just kind of want to hear it. I mean, it's not like a long story. It's just basically tell the story when you were at, when the L train was broken and you had to take a bus over the bridge.
Oh my God. This isn't even a story. This is just a weird thing. This is one of those New York moments where you're just like, holy shit, this city is fucking crazy. So I lived in Brooklyn. I lived on like the first stop in Brooklyn and on the L train. And the L would break down a lot while I was living there. And so when that would happen, that would mean I would have to walk like 20 blocks south to get on the JMZ, but the JMZ was broken too. So that means I'd like walk 20 blocks south and then wait in a long, long line for a bus that would go over the Williamsburg Bridge into Manhattan. And I just remember like, it was one of those things that they're just like packing people onto the buses. Like it's sardines. I remember I finally, after waiting for 45 minutes, I get on this bus and it's free. They're not even like charging people. You know, it's like, this whole thing is so fucked beyond belief. Like, just get on the bus. Like, you have a Metro card. I don't care. Just get on. So I get on this bus and this very clearly homeless man is like, I could get on a bus. And so he's like so excited that he's getting on a bus. So he's like next to me and he's clearly just like thrilled and he wants to like make a big show of the fact that like he's a commuter just like everybody else, but he doesn't know what to talk about. So he starts complaining. And I just remember he goes, this don't make no sense. We're going to take a bus over the bridge. This don't make no sense. The damn bus is probably going to fall off the damn bridge. Like, trying to get everyone worked up that can you believe a bus is going to go over the damn bridge? Gah! It was, and I'm the only one. Again, it's one of those situations where I think this is the fucking funniest thing I've ever heard in my life. Ugh. Nobody else gives a shit. He was great.
What I love about that is, like, you know, you always see these movies about time travelers, like people from the past coming to the future, and they're just like, they're like looking at phones and being like that. I like to think that that's what it would actually be. Yeah. Like, they gotta take a bus.
You like, can't take a bus on a bridge, man. Come on. But I'm on it. It's like, it's just so funny. Oh my God, dude.
That guy has like.
New York is just like, living in New York was the greatest because you would just see shit that was just so shocking and so like out of the ordinary experience of your life that you can only get in New York City, you know?
Yeah, when my parents were dropping me off up at the dorms, the first time like going up to like the dorms up there, there was just this homeless guy just like with his pants down, just jerking off on the side of this, on the right outside the dorm. And they were just like, oh,
yeah,
don't hang out with him.
Yeah.
You know, gotta like,
well, I've told you my story of my, I think I actually did talk about this on the Collective Souls, but whatever. Sorry, Collective Souls. You're going to hear me say it again. The first night I ever moved to New York City, I was walking down St. Mark's Place. And I saw Joey Ramone walking down the street. And I was like, it's fucking Joey Ramone. I'm in New York. Like, let's go New York City. I live here now. I'm so happy.
This is your Sebastian.
Oh, I was overwhelmed. I was truly starstruck. Mm-hmm. Fucking, and Joey Ramone is 7 feet tall. He's very distinct. Mm-hmm. It was like, holy shit. He died like literally a couple months later. The second day I go to New York, I'm like, I'm going back to St. Mark's Place. Who knows what I'll see today? Maybe something else crazy. And I remember I turn up 2nd Avenue. And as I turn the corner, I am presented with a homeless man who's in the middle of the sidewalk. And his pants are around his ankles. He's got his back to me. And he's standing, but he's completely bent over at the waist. And he's got no shirt on. And he's... So I'm presented with his, like, dick and balls and his asshole right above it. It's, like, right mm-hmm. aimed at me. And he's diarrheaing out of his asshole, going down over his dick and balls, down his legs, and some of it is going down his torso onto his face. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
And I just remember it was like,
that makes perfect
sense. This was like,
I've
been in New York 24 hours. And I think I said out loud, I was like, is this? And people, by the way, on the sidewalk are just walking past. They're just like, oh, yeah. Oh, it's this again. Like, they don't give a shit.
What are you supposed to do? You don't want, never make eye contact. You don't want, like, because there's so many crazy people. You don't want them, if you make eye contact, then they'll be like, ugh.
Yeah, you know, you like me? You know?
Yeah.
I think I had a freak out in the sidewalk. I was like, is this what happens here? Is this how this is? Like, it was like, all right, New York. You know, you got me yesterday. It was fucking crazy, dude.
I had a thing where I got on the R train, and I was going back to the dorms or something like that. And I just got in, I walked in, I sat in my seat, and I didn't realize it was one of those seats where you've got a seat, but then there's another seat behind it. Mm-hmm. But there was a homeless guy kind of like sleeping. And so when I got down, I kind of bumped his arm a little bit uh-huh. like that. And I was like, oh, sorry, my bad,
yeah.
You know, kind of thing. And he just stared at me. It was like, oh, fuck. You know, yeah. That's the thing. I made connection with yeah. this fucking crazy
You want to just not exist. You want to be scenery.
Yeah. And so then he's just staring at me. He gets up and he is like, you fucking pushed me. I'm like, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to like that, you know. And then he my stop. He's like yelling at me. My stop came, opened up. And I was like, oh, I got to go. And he spit right into my face. Homeless guy spit. Like, boom. No idea what's in it.
Did it get in your eyes?
Yeah. It was like, boom, like that. And I was so mad. Just immediately, blood pressure goes up. But it's like, wait, you're going to fucking hit a homeless guy.
That's I would like, if he spat in my face. Actually, I wouldn't, but I would no. say that I would. Yeah.
So this is insane.
You don't want to get into a fight with a homeless guy. You don't want to get his blood on. I mean, that's no good.
So my blood pressure's up. I'm furious, and this is what I did. Like, you know, like, and everyone sees it, and they're like, oh, the whole train's looking. And I just look at him and go, this is why you don't have any friends. And I walked off. And I got off the subway and I'm like, what the fuck? Like, this is why you don't have any friends?
What do you think the odds were that he was like, oh, like that really hurt? You know, he's like, oh, and he's looking around at everybody else. He's like, shut up!
I got friends.
I do have friends.
They just live in different states.
Yeah. Wait, now, dude, it's funny. I don't remember what stories I've told on stream and what I haven't. Have I told, remember my train story where I was like going home from high school? So I grew up in DC. I would take the Metro home from high school every day. And maybe I've told this story before. Fuck it. I'm just going to go for it. If people hear the same story twice, I apologize. But I overheard these people on the bench in front of me talking about the surfer Mark Wu who died that year.
Oh, you have told this
I
story.
I have told it on stream?
Yeah, but tell it again.
Oh,
I forget
no, then
where...
that's stupid. I don't want to
no,
do
I,
that.
No, I forget where you... Let's do a poll. Do a poll. It's a good story.
All right, well, let's talk about something else. If people want to hear my Mark Wu story, I'll do a poll. I feel bad. I don't want to tell the same story. That's so lame.
I think you should do it. But here's the... So there's a counterpart to that guy, the bus flipping off the side of the... your story with the bus flipping over the bridge. He has a soulmate from in a story of Sam's, Sam Brown. You know Sam.
I've met him. Yeah, he's yeah. All right.
I'm gonna tell it, but this is his story. Like so.
Oh,
this
Sam's
is,
gonna be pissed.
Do you think?
I love it. Tell it.
No, but I think if Sam ever tells us on a
he's not gonna be really pissed.
Yeah, if he tells it on another thing, you know, it's his story. This is his story. But I love this, and I think this makes me laugh like your story makes me laugh. Which is so Sam, you know, is really into surfing, and he goes down to is it Huntington Beach? I forget where he goes, but he goes down to like you know surf a lot, and then one morning, like he's kind of done for the day, and he's coming back up. He's got his like you know wetsuit on. He's got the surfboard, and there's just this dude who's just like sitting on his car, staring at the ocean. Like with like a bunch of tall boys and like a radio playing and he's just sitting there and he's like, were you out there surfing? Like maybe it's the delivery is the same, but he's like, were you out there surfing? And he's like, and Sam's like, yeah. And he's like, you're crazy. He's like, you know how many sharks are out there? Like that. And Sam's like, ah, I didn't see any sharks like that. And he's like, all right, man, like that. And then so Sam's putting the board into the thing. And then Sam says, a plane is flying, like you know, from LAX, low, you know, and then it goes out, and he looks up, and he goes, "You see that?" And he goes, "They're crazy." And he goes, and this is the best part. He goes, "If that thing goes down out there, it's all sharks."
That's amazing. That guy's the best, dude.
Yeah.
Oh my god. It all comes down to sharks with that guy.
He's
everything.
He's got one fear, and he's just. But he's also terrified of sharks. But he's pushing himself to the limit. He's driving down to the ocean where the sharks live, meeting land every day, and he's just watching it and being like, "This is it. This is danger."
Yeah.
Like.
But that's how, dude. I kind of know that feeling because, like, when I was in New Orleans. I went to a rodeo with some people, and that's just so outside of my like ken, and like watching these dudes strap themselves to a fucking bull that has like its ball cinched, so it's pissed, and this thing is like 2 tons, and then
is that
it's
why
just,
they're pissed?
It's what?
Is that why bulls are pissed?
Yeah,
at the
dude,
rodeo?
They cinch their testicles with a rope, so they're in like they're getting like their balls are getting like pinched, so they're
didn't
just like
that.
Fucking, I'm gonna kill. That's why
didn't
they're so angry.
Yeah.
And it was watching it every single time somebody would go out on this bucking bull. I was just like, I had that guy's attitude. I was like, you're insane. He's doing it on purpose. You know, like I must have looked like a crazy guy. It was so fun. It was so fun. So people do want me to tell the Mark Wu story. So I'll do it. It's not even that great of a story, honestly, but
I like it.
All right. Well, thanks, buddy. Yeah, I was in ninth grade. And I'm taking the subway, the metro home, and I hear these yuppie grown-ups, you know, these other adults, they had to be in their 20s, and they're talking about Mark Wu and how he had just died like 2 months ago. And at that time, I thought surfing was really cool, and I had a friend that moved from Hawaii to my neighborhood. His dad was in the military, and he told me, I talked with John about Mark Wu, and he told me that he met him at a surfing competition one time. And that was very impressive to me in ninth grade. And so I hear these people talking about Mark Wu, and I'm like, I get up before my you know, when it's my stop, and I go, by the way, they talk about Mark Wu, and then there's like 10 more minutes, you know, where they've moved on to other conversations.
This is the part of your personality that is so foreign to me. Like, I don't understand this aspect at all. Like, you know, being like, oh. Like people who I don't know are having a conversation of something I know about. Let me go meet people. Oh. That is for, I
well,
don't know.
Well, let's dive into that. I want to know more about what you're talking about. But so I go up, it's my turn to get off the train. They're still sitting there. And I walk up 10 minutes later, they've moved on. They're not talking about Mark Wu. And I go, I stop in front of them. I go, you guys were talking about Mark Wu, the surfer earlier. Yeah. And they're like, what? like a child is talking to us. They're like, yeah. I'm like, my friend met him. And then they're just looking at me blank. And I'm like, yeah. And then like, and then I step off the train. And as soon as I step off the train, it's just like reality hits me. And I'm like, what the fuck am I doing? Like, what is the reaction I'm expecting from them? Like, no, what, your friend met him? You? What's your deal, man? You seem cool. Like, it was, I'm a fucking idiot, dude.
Would you like to have supper at our house?
Yeah, dude, you seem so fascinated. Hey, this guy's friend knew this dude. Like, crazy.
I love that.
I'm psycho. Annie Hayes, thanks for gifting, dude. But that's not, wait, so do you think that's something you've seen me do a lot?
No. I'm not saying that it's something you do a lot, but I'm saying like that decision where you're like, I know something that they're talking about. I'm going to go talk to them. Like that is such a foreign idea to me. Like I could in a billion years, that would never happen. Like, you know, like that's the, and I think that's part of the thing that makes me, I think so. That's so funny to me about that story.
Yeah. Well, I definitely wouldn't do that again. Yeah.
you're outgoing. You like.
I do like to interact with people. I like to meet people. It's true.
You get out there and mix it up.
Yeah. Our level 5 hype train's going. Wait, let me do some thank yous because I'm being pretty negligent here. PopCon, thank you. Annie Hayes, thank you, my friend. Meadow Hands, Twerkin' Maggle, Thick and Wing, Steven, what's up, buddy? Good to see you. Robbie Bobbles. Robbie Bobbles is a pretty great. That's pretty great. Pork Sweats. I love you, Pork Sweats. You're always doing it, man. You're always fucking bringing it. Prop Like It's Hot. Illodger or 3L Lodger. Couldn't tell you, but thanks for the donation, my friend. Organic Leaf Blower. Thank you. Dimmel Time. I'm getting these names wrong. My eyes are shit. Even with my glasses, I need to up my prescription. Jakey Poo Games. Thanks for the Prime Sub. Cow a Bunghole. How is that not...
That's
very
good.
Common. That's pretty good.
Do you have a real prescription or do you do like Rite Aid glasses?
I do Rite Aid. I got these at CVS.
Okay.
Yeah.
Do you think you will get a real prescription?
No, because I just need plus twos and you can get them anywhere. I have like nicer glasses, but that I order off the internet, but like they're just plus twos. There's no point.
Have you ever done contacts?
Huh?
Have you ever done contacts?
Never in my life.
Hmm.
I'm afraid to.
Yeah.
I feel like I couldn't do it. Like whenever someone has to put like Visine in my eyes, it's like a whole thing. I get all freaked out. Hang on. Yeah. Whip Boy, thanks, buddy. Tugboat Johnson 89. I appreciate you. We're at 214. Oh, Hype Train level 5 is at 333, man. Chipotle Sizzle 36. Thank you for gifting. Dude, going off. Thanks, buddy. I love it. All right. Good shit. We won't know who the president is on November 3rd. We'll get results in December. Well, Maurice, here's my... If Biden wins Florida, it's over. If Biden wins Florida on November 3rd, we're done. There's nothing else to talk about.
I'm kind of thinking Trump wins again.
Oh, dear Lord. Ben Falvey, what's up? What up, Beans? You got Beans. You really think so? I actually don't, but you're terrifying me, man.
Well, here's my thing with it. It's like when you look at the undecideds, there's a lot of undecideds for like in every state. When you look at every state, you got like 6 to 7% undecideds. You know, that seems high for how close we are to the election. So what I think it is it's Trump people who don't want to say it to the pollster.
I don't think that's such a theory. The shy Trump voter who's like ashamed mm-hmm. that they're going to vote for Trump. I don't think those people exist. I don't think Trump voters are that shy.
You don't?
No, I don't think so anymore. Have you heard of the Bannon line?
Mm-mm.
So the Bannon line is something that they talk about a lot now where it's like Steve Bannon famously said, he's like, if they shave 3 to 5% off of what he had in 2016, off of his base, it's unwinnable for him. It's just, that's how delicate his standing is, just mm-hmm. 3 to 5. And he is so below 3 to 5%. Like seniors have abandoned him since he got COVID and by 20 points. Hmm. Women have like fucking left him like crazy. I think the Bannon line is like way in the rearview mirror. So we'll see. People are saying false. I don't know. I don't think I've got it wrong. I could. I get things wrong all the time, but I
someone
I
says the October surprise are coming next week. It's pretty, I mean, this is when it all gets real. It's these last 10 days that everything gets crazy. I think their whole surprise thing is the Hunter Biden stuff.
Yeah. And okay, I'm not voting for Hunter Biden. All right, you got me, and I'm not voting for Antifa. Okay, you win. You know.
Oh, I got some flack on Twitter, because I kind of posted. I was drunk, and I posted.
Drunk tweeting is stop doing that.
That's the only time I think to tweet.
That's how so many people lose their livelihoods, dude.
I don't know. I'm not saying anything bad. I just so there was a thing, and look, I mean, whoever you vote for, Newsboyz is for everybody. But there was a thing that happened this week where they had a picture of Joe Biden kissing his son Hunter
on the cheek.
On the cheek.
Yeah,
not like a Tom Brady, like kissing on the cheek. And like there was a thing going around where everybody was like, "Does this seem like a normal father-son relationship
to you?"
Fuck
those people.
Kind of, and I know because I was drinking, you know, and I was like, "Fuck that!" I was like, "I kiss my kid." I was like, "I still kiss my dad goodbye." You know, like when I'm leaving, I'll kiss him on the cheek like that. I was like, this is not the right take. That's not a good take.
Especially with all the shit that Hunter's been through and all that stuff. It's fucking absurd.
Well, also it's like, you know, whatever you think of Biden's politics, I mean, the guy has had a lot of loss in his life. Like, you know, like his son died, like, you know, like
died.
Yeah. And you know, so I don't know.
He lost two children and his wife.
Yeah, daughter, wife. Yeah. So then, but it was, I was surprised. There was a lot of people tweeting at me that they were kind of like, you know, don't get political. But I was like, I'm not getting political. I'm just saying this is I think this is an objectively bullshit take.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I agree with you, man. I totally agree with you. Zach.
Now, if he did what Tom Brady did, Tom Brady should be in fucking jail.
What did Tom Brady do?
No, I'm joking. Tom Brady kissed his kid on the mouth.
Oh.
Which is weird, but whatever.
I mean, Trump said he would be dating his daughter if she wasn't his daughter. That's actually very creepy.
I bet he wouldn't say that now because she has hit a wall.
I gotta use the bathroom. You think about what you just said. I'll be right back.
Canceled. Everyone says canceled all the time. So how, Fitz, throw out another news thing. What else happened? Hi, Nate. Nate says hello. What else has happened this week? So the debates. Oh, AOC. Someone said AOC on Twitch. Yeah, fucking AOC, like, gets on Twitch and gets, like, 400,000 viewers. And like, I don't even know. I mean, I didn't watch it, but like, yeah, I don't. Is she funny? I don't even get it. Why? Like, 400,000 people. We're trying. We're working our asses off here. We're going up every night, and we can't beat. We got 1,100. It's fucking nuts. We should try to get her to rate us when she's done with her next one. We should all tweet at her like, "Hey, welcome to Twitch." There's these really good. She probably won't want it. If she's ever heard of our show, she probably wouldn't want to like rate us. But we'll just say like you should just tweet at her and tell her that we're like other senators, or what is she? She's a congressman. We're other congressmen that she's probably never heard of. Like we're always at Congress at a different time than she is. So it's like you probably just never run into them. But there's these other really cool congressmen, Trevor Moore, Zach Kreger. They do another great Congress show on Twitch. And next time you're up to 400,000, you know, maybe do them a solid and like, you know, raid them. So
boinga boinga. People are into some boinga shit here. I guess tomorrow will you do some boingas? Boingas is more of a self-suck thing. It's not really a Newsboy thing, guys.
Yeah, I'll do them. You know, I wanted to do it last time, but I just didn't have a pen. I don't have a lot of pens in my house.
Yeah.
I keep running into. I'm gonna use the restroom real quick.
Do your thing. Okay. What other shit, guys? What other Newsboy shit? What happened to AOC? AOC got trolled. What's the deal? When is the last time you guys smoked weed? don't know. I would always smoke weed. Like, I'm sober. I've been sober 5.5 years. So it had to be over 5.5 years ago. I wasn't like a big pothead near the end of my getting fucked up. I would, if I was real wasted and someone had a joint, I would hit it. But I wasn't like buying pot. You know what I mean? That wasn't my thing. Zach, did you watch Dexter? No, I did not. I tried. I couldn't get into it. It was I found Dexter kind of corny. Thank you, me and Puppert. Cheers. Chat. Sorry, guys. It's moving fast. Watch Borat and ban me for one day, Zach. Please. I don't ban people for a day. When I ban you, you're banned forever, dude. I'm fucking hardcore about it. Zach thinks murder is corny. No, I think Dexter is corny. Zach, what's your favorite of Montreal album? Hissing Fun, Are You the Destroyer? Come on. I feel like that's a masterpiece. Have you watched The Good Lord Bird? No, I think I was going to read The Good Lord Bird years ago, but I have not watched it. That's Ethan Hawke cowboy movie, right? Zach, do you love Tim Heidecker? I do. I truly, truly do. Trevor didn't wash his hands again. He's got dick hands and Sam will lick them. Yeah, okay.
No, I always wash my hands. I have OCD. I wash my hands like a motherfucker.
Okay. Oh, yeah, Super Chumps. I read your message. Thank you, man. I've been meaning to get back to you, but I've had an insane week, so forgive me, my friend. But I will get at you. Do you guys like I Think You Should Leave with Tim Robinson? I love it. I think it's fantastic. Limbaugh cancer. Wait, does Rush Limbaugh have cancer?
Terminal?
Yeah. Wow. Well, I'm sorry for his family. RIP James Randi. I don't know who James Randi is, dude. Who's that?
James Randi? I have no idea.
Okay. Zach, do you remember the movie College that you were in with Drake Bell? No. Tell me about it. James Randi was the guy who debunked physics. Okay. What?
Do you know that movie is
He exposed Uri Geller.
Do you know College is on HBO Max right now?
The Amazing Randi. Got it. College is on HBO Max, yeah.
Yep. And, never mind.
What?
No, I was going to say that...
I know
like
what you're going to say.
Oh, you are?
I think I do.
What am I going
to
say?
You were trying to trigger me to go off on Drake Bell.
No, it wasn't.
Oh, really? All right.
But you can if you want.
Yeah, I could if I wanted to.
No, I remember, but the first night I got HBO Max, I was like, oh, what's on HBO Max? And it was like one of the things that popped up. And then the other thing that popped up was one of your wife's movies.
I wonder which one.
I can't remember, but I was like, oh, it's like, it's the Zach family app.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I want the Drake Bell story so bad. I don't really have like a Drake Bell story. Although my wife also did a movie with Drake Bell. And she told me he threw a TV out of his trailer. He ripped the TV out of the wall and he threw it out of the trailer. In my experience with him, I could believe that. I could believe that.
Well, yeah.
Yeah.
I have good Drake Bell stories, but they're just your stories. The stories of yours that I like.
Go ahead. Tell them.
Well, one that I like is that... when you guys would get in the pass van to go to set. Is this okay? I never know, dude, if it's okay.
I don't care.
So I became fascinated with Drake Bell through Zach because Zach would be like, every now and then you talk to Zach when he was doing this movie and it was like, you'd be like, how's the movie going? He's like, I am working with this guy. And, but there's a time period where Drake Bell's like, I'm John Lennon. I'm going to be like the next John Lennon kind of thing.
Yeah.
So he had just finished an album. And then whenever you guys would get in the pass van at the hotel to go to set, he would be like, can we play my album? Like, which is insane.
In his defense, it happened one time. It only happened once. Okay. But yeah, it was one of those things. It's like, you know, you're shooting late. It's probably 4 a.m. or something. And we're like exhausted. We get back in the 16-pass van that's full of people who have just worked 14 hours. And he's like, play this. And he like passes his album up to play his album. And his album is like happy bubblegum music. And he's like, turn it up. Go to track 6. Dude, go to track 6. No, dude, skip. Dude, skip. Yeah, this is it. Start it over. Turn it up. And it was just like, everyone in the van is just like, what the fuck are you doing?
It's that thing. It's so for, I mean, like, and like, I'm giving credit. Like, I mean, like, I've done a couple music albums, and when you just finish doing the album,
you're thrilled with it. I've been there too, dude.
Really into it. And so, like, I'm not going to say that, like, you know, when my album's done, I don't listen to it. I listen to it a lot, you know, by myself, you know, drinking and doing drugs. Like, you're supposed to listen to your album, like, you know, but like, the idea, and every now and then, if I want, like, I'll get one of my friends and be like, hey, can I show you some songs? And you tell me which ones, you know, want to cut them down.
And the way to do that, by the way, is not while you're in the same room with them. You say,
oh, yeah.
Can I send you some songs? You listen to them at your leisure. Yeah. And if you have thoughts, send them to me. If you don't worry.
And even when I do it, even when I'm showing it to you or Sam or like people that I'm very tight with, I apologize my ass off.
Yeah.
I'm like, I am so sorry, but I really need someone else to look at this. I need a sounding board. Can you please like just tell me which ones are your favorites, like that kind of thing. And I'm like, I'll buy you a case of beer, whatever the fuck. Like,
it's,
you know,
like asking someone to drive you to the airport. It's like,
exactly. Yeah,
this
exactly.
is an imposition.
Yeah.
People are talking about Josh. I have also spent some time with Josh from Jake and Josh, and I have to say Josh Peck is a very lovely person. Yeah, so whatever. Ralph Wiggum, you're right. You're right. Although Drake Bell, dude, can you do me a favor? There's a song that my wife and I quote on realistically once a week.
Is it, can I guess?
Yeah.
Is it Bitchcraft?
Yeah. Will you just play a little bit of Bitchcraft? It's so fucking funny, dude. I fucking love this. The chorus of this song, whenever my wife is annoying me, I just break out into the chorus of this song. It's fucking lovely. Watch Drake soloing on YouTube. It's so cringe. I would love to. I'd love to. Oh, did you hear Jeff Bridges has lymphoma? Fuck.
Yeah, that sucks. But it's a good prognosis. Like, I don't think it's fatal.
Okay. All right. That fucking crushes me. Eh, no, it doesn't. But I love Jeff Bridges.
You're a big Starman fan.
I've never seen Starman. Oh, my
I remember
God.
It was.
Wait,
it played...
I think he has a music video, dude. We got to watch the music video for it.
Bitchcraft music video.
And try it one word. I think that's. There it is. Oh, God. Oh, my God.
Okay. Guys, here
get
we go.
Get ready. Whenever Sarah's annoying me, I'm always like, I'm tired of all your bitchcraft. It's pretty fun.
Hold on, anyway, I got him.
Yeah, people are like, get it off. Dude, remember in Wedding Crasher where that guy's singing, do you really want to hurt me? And somebody in the crowd off camera is like, you suck! Do you know that moment? It is the greatest moment of that whole fucking movie. Jesus Christ.
Do you think the moment where he realized that witchcraft rhymes with bitch, he was like, oh!
Yes, I do. I do. Oh, my God. Did I say Wedding Crashers? I meant Wedding Singer. Thank you, Wedding Singer. I got it. I fucked it up.
He's had a rough go of it, hasn't he?
Drake Bell?
Yeah.
I couldn't tell you. I would. I don't know. I'm not going to speculate.
Doesn't he live near you?
Not anymore. Yeah.
We should get him on the show. That'd be great.
Oh boy. Let's. Yeah. Another time. Hey Zach and Trevor, I've been watching Whitest Kid since college, around 2008. Just wanted to say thanks for the laughs. I look forward to any future stuff you guys do. These streams have been the most surprisingly pleasant part of the pandemic oscillation. Cheers. Spatial awareness. Thanks, buddy. I appreciate that.
Thanks. That's nice. That's always nice when people, you get a lot of like things where people are like, oh, you know, thanks for doing this during the pandemic kind of thing.
Yeah. It does make it more fun for us to have our to have praise heaped upon us. I don't know. What am I saying?
Well, here's the thing. It's nice that people acknowledge it.
There you
because,
go.
because, you know, the thing is, we don't need to do this. You know, like we don't need the love or anything like that. We're very functioning members in society, very full wives. And
truth be told, we'd be doing Newsboyz just as happily without anybody watching. You know?
Absolutely. And we have. And so when we finished the show, we were like, we're like, you don't, I mean, that was perfection. We're done. And so we just didn't do anything for 10 years. But then when this virus happened, we were like, I think they need us.
Yeah.
Yeah. And that's why we came back.
Yeah. Yeah. In August 2020, his former girlfriend, Melissa, who actually, I know Melissa, she's a lovely person. I'm just reading a headline here. Accused him of verbal and physical abuse during their three-year relationship in the late 2000s. Bell has denied the allegations. All right. That's an article you can read if you like.
I believe him.
Okay.
No, I don't. Actually, I have no idea. What did he do? She said she did what?
I don't know.
No, I believe her. I don't know where I'm going.
Why you gotta say it with a smirk?
Because
I believe her. Wink.
It's crazy to hear a news story and be like, I believe one of them.
Yeah. Well,
you believe the person who says that the yeah. Of course he probably fuck. Oh, we're gonna probably get sued if you.
Yeah. Mm. Let's just move forwards, Lucifer.
Well, let's go back to this for a second. Zach, what do you think? You've met him. Does he seem like the kind of guy that would
Oh wow, here's a great hang on, let me read what this one says. Bell was arrested. Oh, it's another Bell thing. Well, I started it, so I gotta finish it. Bell was arrested on December 21st, 2015 for driving under the influence in Glendale, California at 2:45 a.m. after police officers witnessed him swerving and driving well over the speed limit. 135. There's no way that's true. He was subsequently released on $20,000 bond and pleaded not guilty. 135? Give me a break, dude.
That's so cool.
What car even goes that fast that you can...
He's not going to do that.
There's no way.
Yeah.
Although, dude, do you remember on the 5 in between my current house and your old house? You know, they have the like road signs, you know, like the exit signs above the highway. I'm sure they do it in every state. Some dude was going so fast, he rolled his car, he got flung from his car, and he embedded himself in the road sign. So his corpse was just like hanging above morning commuter traffic for like, that's fucking amazing, dude.
Yeah.
California, baby.
The
would you guys ever consider doing a live action movie that was like a feature length sketch where you play every part including extras? Sure. Yeah.
Someone says, what is the walk-in thing? Because that's from your stream.
Oh,
right?
Yeah. I was doing, people were coming on the Discord and doing different Christopher Walken impressions. I know you don't do a Christopher Walken impression.
I don't really do impressions.
I know. That's not a youth. That's not something you do.
Like, I could try one. I've never, ever tried one in my life. He goes like, he talks. I'm just doing Borat because I watched Borat last night.
Keep going.
He's like, my wife.
No, do Walken.
Yeah, I'm Christopher Walken. Oh, so we were watching Borat.
No, really actually try a Christopher Walken impression.
Okay, but I want to say this real quick. So like last night, we were watching Borat. And so my wife and I were like, oh, we'll watch the new Borat movie. I'm like, I love Borat. I haven't seen Borat forever like that. She's like, oh, okay, cool. Like, you know, I was like, watch it. I'm like, my wife. And she's like, yep. And I'm like, yeah, baby. And she's like, that's not Borat. I'm like, yeah, it is. Like, she's like, do I make you horny? Like, yeah. she's like, you're doing Austin Powers. But I'm like, no, 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 it's Borat. Like, you know, like that. Like,
that's pretty good. All right.
Walking. So what is the main thing that people do the impression for him with?
I'm not even going to tell you. I just want to see what you come out with.
I'm a Christopher Walken.
Oh my god.
No, he's like, I'm Chris. I don't know how he talks. I don't know. I don't see his movies. He's in Deer Hunter, right? He's I was in Deer Hunter.
Trevor, I'm not exaggerating. That's the worst Christopher Walken I've ever heard.
I don't know. I don't know what the guy sounds like. He's very stilted.
He's like, I'll be damned.
Oh, right.
Like
that's
a guy like you. Yeah. Tell him, you know, come on.
Ugh. I pushed Natalie Wood off a boat. I pushed Natalie Wood off a boat.
My God, dude.
My wife, I push her off a boat.
Wait, what is this? The ice is going to break. What is that? Is that a line of his? I feel like that's ringing a bell. The ice is going to break. I don't know.
The ice.
Ugh.
Yeah. Christopher Walken's just Borat.
It's not. Oh, it's Dead Zone. Right. Oh my God. Yeah. Yeah, some people on my Collective Souls were pretty good. Some were terrible. You know what?
That seems to be like the impression that everyone besides me can do. Like, that's like the
easy. No, it's hard. Christopher Walken's hard. Yeah. Every accent is just Borat, somebody says. All right, here we go. In March 2018, Drake Bell was accused of paying two Bolivian prostitutes to defecate in his mouth in exchange for $5,000. Upon realizing who he was, they allegedly attempted to get more money out of Bell after the fact. Upon his refusal, they contacted a number of news agencies trying to publish their story, which was broken by TMZ. This is from his wiki page. I don't believe
We got to get Drakey B on the show.
I don't think that's real. I think somebody's trolling me to get me to just read Drake Bell headlines, which is actually funny. But I don't think that's true. God. I think that's a fake one.
Would you ever pay a Brazilian prostitute to shit in your mouth?
If you asked me that 10 years ago,
mm-hmm.
I would have still said no.
That's one of those things that, like, you know, like I'm sure it's a real kink.
Oh yeah,
I'm sure.
Yeah,
of course. But like, part of me doesn't believe it. Like, part of me just like that. Part of me is like, that's only for comedy. You know, when people are like, hey, he paid her to shit on him. Like, I'm like, that doesn't really happen, does it? Yeah. Of course it does. But still, like, it seems weird.
Do you remember, our friend Jay Boog in Brooklyn?
Yeah.
I remember I went to his, like, little, like, squat basement living thing. And he was like, hey. This is a friend we knew in Brooklyn who was like this. Tattooed head to toe. Literally. He's a skinhead. So he had a bald head with, like, a fucking tattoo all over his head.
Puerto Rican skinhead. Which is a fascinating person.
And not racist. He's part of the whole anti-racist skins thing. Mm-hmm. He's a sharp. But
was he always, or was he?
Always.
Did
he he had the anti-racist tattoo. He was like, yeah.
Okay.
He was part of like a...
Okay.
No.
Great guy.
He was also a badass. That dude has been shot and stabbed. I mean, he was one of the most fucking wild people I ever knew in my life.
He's the coolest. He was also a model who's the weird fucking looking lady who's like a big deal in the fashion industry? She's got the weird fucked up face. Her brother got shot. Versace.
Oh, fucking Donatella Versace?
Yeah, there's an ad where it's like him. He's like a young, this is like when we knew him. Like, he's like a 22-year-old dude who's like ripped, all these fucking tattoos. And she's like lying, and she looks like a fucking weird mutant cat lady.
Oh,
like that.
I haven't seen that.
Oh, yeah. He was like a successful model at the same time, too. Yeah.
Anyway, I remember I went to his like little squat, and he was like, hey, you want to see something cool? I was like, yeah. And he just put on this like German shit porn. And I guess at the time I was like probably 21. I felt like I'd been around the block and seen some shit, but dude, I was like shocked. Like it was one of those things. It was like seeing pornography the very first, like, you ever, I don't know if you saw porn when you're like too young, where you're just kind of like, oh God, that's what it looks like. It's like, there's like a visceral, like physical, like, oh, when you're like, dude, it was like, yeah. And later I would watch Two Girls, One Cup like all the time for laughs. Like when we were like working, we would make people watch Two Girls, One Cup. But the first time I saw someone shitting into somebody's mouth, I'll never forget it. Never forget it.
The thing that, I think Jay Boog had that, because he was like, we were all from, you know, different areas of the East Coast, and we were like, you know, we're out of high school and we're going up to live in New York, and we're like kind of seeing the world for the first time the way the world really is. Jay Boog was one of these dudes who was like born in like the fucking like gritty New York kind of.
He grew up fighting in the street.
Yeah. You know, by the time he was 10 years old, he was basically a 35-year-old, like, you know, kind of like, he was like, and the thing that blew my mind about him, I remember the first couple times we were talking, we hung out, and then people had gone to his place, and that he had what he called the piss couch. You remember this?
No.
He had a couch in his apartment that you would just piss on. And so,
I don't remember that.
Because his bathroom was fucked up. Like, the toilet was, like, fucked. And so he'd be like, I gotta go to the bathroom. And he'd be like, oh, you gotta use the piss couch. Like, and we're like, what? And people just fucking piss on a couch. Like, and I was like, that is so fucking crazy. And so, like, I don't give a fuck cool in a weird way. Yeah. Like, I was like, you're on a fucking different level.
He
than
really
anything
was,
that
man.
I'm like,
yeah. Where do you shit in there?
I don't know. It wasn't
obviously
shit.
You shit in the bed. I'm not an animal, bro.
The shit cupboard.
Yeah. All right, hang on. On April 30th, 2012, Bell's property in Orange Walk Town, Belize, was raided by the gang suppression unit of the Belize Police Department. At the time, Bell was in bed with a girlfriend. A GSU press release stated that Bell was arrested for unlicensed drug manufacturing and possession of an unlicensed weapon. He was released without charge. Belize police spokesman Rafael Martinez confirmed that Bell was neither convicted nor charged, only suspected. I don't think that's real, man.
These are all very cool. Like,
yeah,
he's
I
like
just
a
don't
dork.
Think that's real, man.
I mean, not a dork in a like a whatever. He's probably a Greek. I don't know.
Yeah.
You know, but like that doesn't. I don't buy it.
Yeah.
The
hey,
last
by the way,
time,
Derek. I know, dude.
What happened?
My buddy Derek is like modding our shit. He's like, Zach, these are all fake. I fucking know these are fake, dude. What's the screwdriver for? Wouldn't you like to know, you fuck?
That's your.
Oh, John McAfee. I guess John McAfee had someone shit in his mouth or something.
Yeah, but he's crazy.
Was he? Did he have some story this week? I think he had a story.
I think he got arrested. He got arrested.
Derek says, I just had a look on my face like I was intertwined in the story. No, I just think it's funny if I read out all the fake stories that people are writing about it. But I guess now I've called it out, so the joke is dead.
Yeah, thanks. Who is that?
Derek.
Way to go, Derek.
Way to go, Derek. God damn it. John McAfee will eat his dick on national television at the end of the year. This is not fake.
No, that's not fake.
Yeah, that's real.
No,
that's
he real. Said he will. But he's insane. He has said that.
No, shut the fuck up.
No, he has.
John McAfee has said he's going to eat his own dick on TV.
Yes.
Show me an article.
Ugh.
I just don't believe you, man. John McAfee, enough is enough. Whale fucking is non-consensual bullshit. A humpback whale weighs 70,000 pounds, is 50 feet long, and can die, blah, blah, blah. I don't know what that is. Zach, learn to Google. If I Google everything, well, I'm going to be fucking up the stream, okay? I got my hands full already.
So here you go. It was about Bitcoin. If Bitcoin wasn't above something, here we go. See it?
Mm-hmm.
If one Bitcoin, 500K within 3 years. If not, I will eat my dick on national television. When I predicted Bitcoin at 500,000 by the end of 2020, it used to be a model that predicted 5,000 at the end of 2020. Bitcoin is now accelerated much faster than my model. So I will now predict Bitcoin at 1 million by the end of 2020. I will still eat my dick.
All right. Yeah. You got me on that one, man. That's real.
No, he's insane. I went to, you know, that place where like he allegedly murdered those people in Belize.
Yeah. Wait, have you seen that documentary?
Yeah. Yeah.
It's great.
I was there like a month later.
Oh, that's great.
Like, and like two doors down from that. Like we rented a place like right there. And that's all anyone was talking about. And they're like, now he's in like Guatemala or some shit. Like, you know, kind of thing. But it was like, we had like gotten in just as that shit was happening.
Oh man. All right. I gotta move on from all this Bell shit. And I actually feel like I'm gonna have to go in and retroactively pull it out of this stream.
Oh, really?
I don't want to get sued. I feel like this could go south.
Have we said anything that could get us sued? I don't think so.
I don't know.
Like, we don't know anything.
Yeah, I don't know. I have all sorts of paranormal. Trevor, do you know I have a lot of paranormal delusions? Do you know that about me? Zach or Trevor, did you guys like Van Halen? I did like Van Halen. Yeah. They weren't one of my big bands, but I like them.
I mean, I don't hate them, but I hated music in the 80s. Like when I was a kid. I still don't really love it. Like,
you don't
love
80s music or music?
No, 80s music.
Yeah.
Like, but I remember like I would be on a you know, like a tour bus with my parents. My parents were Christian rock singers in the 80s, and all they would listen to is like Christian music. And so I would like, I had a radio in the back, and I would like try to listen to like real music. And so like I would like with my headphones so no one could hear me, and I would listen to as we go through a town, I'd be like, ooh, try to find it. And I would hear what was on the radio back then, and it was all fucking garbage. It was like, you know, there was like there's like that girl is poison. It was just like bullshit. I mean, I'm sure there was good music. I know there's good music happening out there, but like not on the radio at that point.
Yeah.
And I really, it was like, huh, I guess I don't like music.
Yeah.
You know, and it wasn't until like, honestly,
Nirvana.
Yeah. That's very boomer. But it wasn't until my uncle gave me the Nevermind album on cassette. Like he had recorded it off his CD, and I was like, oh, this is cool. Like, you know, kind of.
It's funny. I remember where I was the first time I heard Nirvana. It was like, oh, fuck. This changes everything. All right. Let me do some call outs. People are saying I should do some. Let me do this. Harry Spanksters. Thanks for the sub.
Funny.
Critical Moments. Thank you, my friend, for gifting. I appreciate it. Lucifer's Left Nuts. Thanks for subbing, friend. Ellie Rocks. Thank you. Nate Blackest. You fuck. Hold On and Hang On. Spiffy McWiffleby. Benmo 93 or Brent Bremo. I can't fucking read. Ellie Rocks. Hold On and Hang On. That's a good name. I like that. Ben Falvey. Thanks, buddy. Okay, wait. I feel like I might. Let me go check the other website because I might. That one doesn't show donations for some reason.
Someone says this has been a mellow episode in a way.
Yeah, I guess in a way it has. In a way. You know, in a someone way says, it has been.
Someone says, was Trevor drinking during last B&M? I got a lot of shit for the last B&M.
Well, you were drinking during the last B&M, right?
I don't feel
like that's why you behaved so poorly.
No.
I mean, what are people? What's people's main complaint with you in the last B&M?
Oh, they just think that I'm being an asshole.
Yeah, but those people don't get it. That's like, I don't think you're being an asshole. I think that you are.
Yeah, so it says Trevor was being douchey.
No. Dude, well, someone in chat is always going to say something mean to you. That's the deal.
No, I think a lot of people are siding with Sam and Sam
they're,
and my.
They're wrong.
Well, no, but I just think that, you know, and here's the thing. You know, like, you don't. I've been a little surprised that we have so many little bitches in our fan base. Like that's been the thing that like shocked me about.
I like where you went with that. That was funny. No, dude. Here's the thing. Futt has always been crazy and trying to get away with whatever he can. That's what makes Futt Futt. So.
Well, here's the thing. I actually think that there's a lot of people who have, like, you know, back 20 years ago, we were a comedy troupe, and like now we're like we're esport influencers now. So, like I think a lot of people who have gotten into this Buckerson and Myers are into role playing tabletop games.
Oh, you think they're not Whitest Kids fans? They're like D&D fans that found Buckerson and Myers? I doubt it.
I don't know. But I feel like there's a bunch of people or a lot of the people who watch Buckerson and Myers like the role play tabletop thing. And I think that Sam actually tries to play. But I have
Dude,
zero.
Dude, what has Sam really done in the last episode? What did he do besides get mad?
I mean,
He punched a zombie. I'm fucking, for the last three episodes, I'm doing everything.
But he like cares about the rules and all that stuff like that, which I'll be honest, I don't. Like I don't. Like, you know, like I think I don't know.
I hope Sam.
How many episodes do you want to go with Buckerson?
I think we got two max. Two more max. I mean, honestly, I feel like we could end it on the next one.
You want
to
end it?
I'm not saying I want to. It just feels like it feels like tensions. It's not sustainable. Someone's gonna try and kill somebody.
Here's what I would say. I say we end it at 10, but we don't end it. We pause it. And we do that as a season. And then we go do something else. Yeah. Like I like the role play thing. I like the idea that we were talking about where we do New York.
That's what
like
I want to do.
Modern time New York. We do modern time New York, do 10 episodes of that, and then maybe we revisit Buckerson and Myers and see where those guys are. You know,
Lurking Deep, what up, dude? That's my friend Todd from England. What's up, Lurking? That's an interesting idea, but here's the thing. I don't really love that plan, because if we have this like subconscious idea that will like bring the Buckerson and Myers characters back for another season, then you and Sam are going to pull punches and no one's going to die. And quite frankly, somebody needs to die.
Oh, Zach, that ain't going to fucking happen. I'm not talking about like not all of our characters might be the same characters. You could still, but we still go back to
but
this
But just
world.
Go back to like, another like D&D kind of vibe.
Yeah, or just pick up whoever characters are left, you know, but like Sam or I are dead by the end of this thing.
Yeah.
Like, yeah. And it's going to be Sam.
Yeah. People are saying stream Buckerson and Myers. You guys don't want that. Trust me. We could like do some paywall in front of like the raw footage. I'll upload the raw footage of Buckerson and Myers and people will just be bored out of their fucking brains.
Yeah. Here's why it's not good. Timmy does a fantastic job. Like, I think Timmy is a great, dungeon
DM,
master.
GM, yeah. Whatever.
He's fucking great. I mean, I don't know. This is the only time I've ever played, so I don't know. He could.
Yeah, for all I know, he's
like,
terrible.
It
I have
sounds
no idea.
Like it. If people seem to like it.
Yeah.
But it's like so much of these games is like rolling for things. And that's what we cut out. It's not like we're cutting out anything that's funny. We're cutting out all of the stuff where it's like, wait a minute. Or like, you know, you got to look something up and figure out what this guy's like power is versus that. That's all that gets cut out.
Yeah. And bathroom breaks.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. A lot of bathroom breaks.
Yeah.
Someone says, fuck you, Trevor. If you kill Bobo, I will hunt you down in real life and smack the fuck out of your hand. A painful high five.
Okay.
Okay. Seems weird.
Yeah.
Seems extreme for
Trevor's free. Monstrous amount of drinking is cut out too. No. Have you seen Mitch McConnell's hands? We already talked about that.
What was the thing with my monstrous amount of drinking?
Is also cut out of the streams.
Oh. No, it's all in there.
It's in. That's in.
That's in there.
Yeah. Do you like grilled cheese? My one question. Yeah. Who doesn't like grilled cheese? Have you ever had that grilled cheese restaurant next to the Arclight? There's like a...
I don't like grilled cheese.
You don't like grilled cheese?
Never have. Even as a kid. Hated it.
Get out of here. That's weird. Do you like cheese burgers?
I like cheese burgers.
So you like cheese on things.
Yeah, yeah. I'm not anti-cheese. I just don't like... There's something about... It's just like bread and cheese... And it like, it just kind of tastes like, eh. I also don't like quesadillas.
You know what? I was going to ask you, like, I give a shit about your don't like quesadillas. All right.
This is the worst news, boys.
We bottomed out. All right, everybody. Thanks, guys. Sorry about
Good
that.
Night.
See
Good
you
night,
next
everybody.
Week, Newsboyz. Wait, you know what I wanted to ask? What's your earliest memory?
Oh,
and I don't know if there's a story here. I literally am just curious.
It's not a story, but I have talked about, I do know what my earliest memory is. My earliest memory is when I lived in New Jersey as a kid. It was before I lived in Virginia, and, my parents were, street singers in New York. And so they would basically, what they did for money is they would sing on the Staten Island Ferry all day. To people who had to go because you have a captive audience, like it's like a 30-minute, you know, ferry kind of thing.
And would they sing Jesus songs on the ferry?
No. They would sing like Sonny and Cher and things like that. They would
Mamas
sing
and
like
Papas and shit.
Yeah, contemporary things. So that's what they did for money, and we lived in Hoboken, Virginia, Hoboken, New Jersey, and I remember my nanny taking me to the grocery store and me being in a wagon, like a radio flyer wagon, and seeing grass growing through the cement on the sidewalk and just being horribly depressed.
Horribly depressed?
Yeah.
How old were you?
I had to be below the age of three. It's my earliest memory because like we moved to Virginia when I was three, but I was probably two and a half. And I remember being very upset that the grass was destroying the sidewalk.
Wow.
Which is a weird way to take that.
Yep.
You know, but it was like, oh, this sidewalk, the grass is growing through the cracks and it's breaking the sidewalk. And I didn't like that and it depressed me.
Wow.
That's my earliest memory.
No shit.
What's yours?
Getting buckled into a car seat. You know,
so that's like, got to be very young too.
Yeah, I had to be like a little baby probably. And then I have a bunch of memories at like the church that we went to when I was like 3 and under. Yeah.
Did you like church? You did.
At that age,
it
was like, like didn't enter into it. It was like, you know, every situation you're a hostage, you know? So it was like before you can even reckon that like that you have any choice of where you are. But you know what I remember? I remember I was sitting in like a semicircle on the floor in Sunday school. So like my mom was in church and me and all the little kids were, you know, you're in Sunday school in this little nursery, right? Mm-hmm. I remember this woman, the teacher was like reading a book to us. I was like sitting on the floor listening to her read a book. Have I told you this story?
No.
Dude, so she's reading a book. She's like looking at the kids, reading a book. And then she looks at me and throws the book, grabs me, and just goes running out of the room. And I'm like, I'm getting carried under her arm. So like I'm looking behind as we're like getting, as I'm getting like carted out of the room. And I see there's like weird stuff on the ground. She runs me into the bathroom. She like sits me on a stall. I'm crying. I don't know what the fuck's going on. And
you're just crying because this is crazy.
I'm like, what is happening? Why are you grabbing me? Where are we? Why am I in a bathroom alone with this teacher? And then she's like, she leaves me there alone. So I'm just, she's like, don't move. So I'm just sitting on this toilet, which I'm like not old enough to be doing. And like, I don't know how much time goes by. And then my mom comes in and like into the boys' room and like kneels down in front of me. He's like, Zach? And I'm like, what? I'm like so upset. And she's like, do you know why you're here? I'm like, no. She's like, you pooped on the floor. I was just sitting listening to this lady read a book, just shitting onto myself and on the floor. So she sees me, she's like, fuck, and like runs me out of the room.
You were like upside down and the shit was just going over your balls into your mouth. Like
that's when I unlocked that memory. Oh my God.
Wow.
Yeah, man.
That's crazy.
Yeah.
I remember the thing for me, like that freaked me out about church, you know, as a kid was the, everything in unison, you know, like it was, you know, you read a part of the Bible, and then everybody in the church reads a part together.
Right. The call and response. Would you guys do the Nicene Creed?
Yeah, but it was just something about that, like, set up red flags. It was warning flags. And
even
it just
as a
like,
kid.
Yeah, I was like, I don't like it. I don't like this. I don't, you know, like, I don't like the everybody, the groupthink kind of thing. Like, you know, and to be honest, like, you know, and I've run into this a little bit in my later life, like, you know, even stuff that I agree with, you know, like, or causes that I agree with, you know, when everyone's like, oh, you got to change, you know, your Facebook profile to something, you know, like,
oh, like Blackout Tuesday.
Or like, you know, and there was the horrible terror attack in France, and then everybody wanted you to like change your thing to be like the colors of the French flag or something like that. Like that kind of stuff. Like it's still same thing, you know, where I'm like, I don't like us. I don't like everybody doing things in unison.
I agree with you. I don't think that's a lot of that stuff is at all necessary. I certainly don't know how productive it is, but it's not necessary. But I do sometimes rankle if like there's something very serious happening, and then I go on and I see some dickhead is like, made brownies today, thinking about trying my new recipe of this, or like, hey, gonna, you know, check out this new video I uploaded. I'm like, dude, fuck you. Like, I definitely get into that.
I mean, I don't know. I never like, I'm kind of like, I think when I see that, I'm always like, it just makes me laugh. I'm like, that dude's just fucking like, you know, unaware. I don't know. Yeah. I don't know. But I also think that I think a problem I have is that I'm a little bit of a contrarian, which like I don't think is cool, you know, but it's kind of like if everybody, like I remember when that Da Vinci Code, everybody loved the Da Vinci Code.
Again, you that? Have the most funny, you know, it's pronounced Da Vinci.
Da Wait, Vinci. What did I say?
God.
What did I say?
He said Da Vinci.
That wasn't on purpose, that one.
He said it twice.
Da Vinci Code.
Like everyone in chat is noticing. It's not just me.
I'm an idiot. I don't know how to say things.
Da Vinci code. You know how to say Leonardo da Vinci. All right, keep going. Doesn't matter. But it's very funny. All right. But yeah, so you don't like the Da Vinci code.
Well, it was like, and also Hamilton, you know, kind of thing. Like all of a sudden, when out of nowhere, everybody is like, oh my God, have you seen Hamilton? Or like, oh my God, have you read the Da Vinci code? Da Vinci.
You got it right there.
Yeah, thank you. I'm just kind of like, I bet it sucks, you know? And then when I see it, I have that in my head the whole time. I'm like, this sucks, like, you know, kind of thing. And then even if it's good, I'm like, all right, it's not as bad as I thought, you know, kind of thing. Yeah. But it's like, yeah, anytime like, you know, like moms get into something, and yeah, I'm like, ah, yeah, you know.
Did you see the Book of Mormon?
No. But I like those guys. Like, I love.
Also, to your credit, yeah, those guys are the best. But to your credit, yeah. Like, Breaking Bad, one of your favorite shows ever, right? And that is the show that's universally the best show ever. So it's like, you're not, when something is real quality that's undeniable, yeah. you're down with it.
And I had that going into it, where I was like, all right, let's see this cool show. I'm like, oh, this is cool, you know.
Yeah, it's super cool. Did you see Cannibal the Musical? Yep, loved it.
Someone said Narcos. Narcos is my favorite television show that's ever been made. Narcos, fucking love Narcos.
Especially season 3. Season 3 is fucking insane.
You introduced me to a guy from Narcos and I was psyched.
Yeah, my buddy Michael. Yeah.
Yeah.
Ozark better than Breaking Bad? You're just so wrong, dude. I don't even... What are you doing?
What's better than Breaking Bad?
Ozark? Come on.
I've never seen it.
That's someone trolling.
But it also seems like Ozark... I mean, I don't know. I've never seen Ozark. But it seems like, to me... who's just going to make an opinion off of nothing. Ozark is just trying to do Breaking Bad. And I don't think if you're post Breaking Bad doing a Breaking Bad show, that's not as cool.
Right. I don't know if Ozark's trying to do Breaking Bad. I've only seen like 3 episodes of it, but I mean, it's whatever. Yeah, is Better Call Saul fantastic? I feel like everyone says it's like, dude, it's actually better than Breaking Bad. I feel like people say that all the time.
I watched 2 seasons and I got bored and I stopped watching it. Same. But people love it.
Yeah. I couldn't get through it. I've tried it twice. I've tried to get through it. I can't do it.
You know what I don't like? The Wire. Which is supposed to be the greatest show of all time.
The Wire is fucking amazing, but like I also had a false start with The Wire where I tried it and I was like, this is fucking corny. And then I got through like 4 episodes and then I was in and I burned through The Wire like all seasons and a week.
I see chat's mad. They're saying The Wire's great. I know
The Wire
it's
great.
I'm not saying The Wire's bad. Yeah. It's me. But it's also one of these things where it's like it's hyped up too much. Like, you know, everyone like is like The Wire's the greatest show of all time. You're watching it and you're like, I'm bored.
Wait,
like,
did you watch Game of Thrones?
I watched Game of Thrones, but it was because everybody in the world was watching Game of Thrones.
You didn't like it?
I always fucking hated that dragon lady.
Uh-huh.
From the beginning.
The fuck was her name? Blondie. What's her name?
Yeah. Yeah. I thought she was the villain from day one, you know? And so then at that last season, when everyone's like, what? She's the bad guy? I'm like, yeah, she's the fucking bad guy. She's fucking psycho. Like, you know, like nobody's. So like, I didn't understand like everyone's hate of, I mean, to me also, because the thing is like, everyone's like, oh, the books. I never read the books. You know, and they'd be like, you know, once they got past the books is when I thought it got good, because then shit happened every episode. Like you would watch all those Game of Thrones things and there'd be nothing fucking going on. And then the last 5 minutes, they'd be like, oh, well, here's something. And then that's the setup for the next episode. Mm. It was just nothing with then like a cliffhanger. So like once the fat fucking, what's his name, dude? The guy who's like, doesn't like to write, but he's a famous writer. The big fat fucking.
George R. R. Martin?
Yes. Once he like once they got past his books, they could just be like, all right, let's make this entertaining kind of thing. What?
I don't know why I'm just cracking up the way you refer to him. With that fat guy. Who's that fat guy? He doesn't like to write, but he's a writer. You know, real fat. Like, it's just funny to me, man.
Well, what the fuck has he been doing? I mean, that's the thing. It's like, you know.
Yeah.
You know, like, all right, you're a writer, and you write. And honestly, you're not even a real writer. You write, like, dragon shit.
Dude, like, he's an amazing writer.
Sure.
Oh,
like, you know, so he's like writing about wizards and elves and stuff. And like, you know, he happens to get a show be a huge hit. Like, so the world, the money trucks are just backing themselves up into his house and just dumping money in his front yard. And they're like, what are you going to do now? And then he's like, ah, just like, I'm just gonna, you know, I just fucking eat a lot, I guess. I don't know. Like, you know, it's been like 7 years since he's written anything. Like,
Chad is fucking cracking me up right now. I can't even read some of these comments out loud. Oh my God. I liked Game of Thrones up until the last season. I thought the last season was a major bummer, but other than that, I was into it, man.
I like that girl, the girl who was mad at everybody and wanted to kill everyone.
Oh,
but
Arya?
She was cool. Yeah. I liked
dude,
the guy.
Didn't that big blonde lady look like Pete Holmes? Every time I'd see it, I'd be like, fucking yeah. Pete Holmes, dude.
She does. You're right. I never thought about that, but you're right.
She's exactly like him.
She was in that shitty Star Wars too. Like, or she was in all of them. Like, where they're like, here's a character and she never got to do anything.
Yeah.
I liked the guy who was Littlefinger. I liked Littlefinger. He was my favorite character.
Yeah, he's fantastic.
Yeah. And then I liked the eunuch guy, the bald guy, the eunuch.
Oh yeah, the spider. Yeah, he's fantastic. Yeah. He's awesome too, man. I mean, great characters.
Yeah.
It's a great show until the end.
But honestly, you could have told that story in 3 seasons.
I had no complaints until the end. What else?
What's your favorite TV show right now?
Dude, I don't really watch that much, man. I'm like, right now I'm like doing a Coen Brothers kind of redo. I'm like watching the Coen Brothers. I watch all this Kubrick shit. I'm like fucking, I don't know. Dave. I like Dave.
Oh, really? Is that good?
Yeah, I think it's great.
Somebody says George R. R. Martin has made more money with his books than Miss March and the Civil War on Drugs combined, which is a great tweet. Or whatever it is.
Yeah. Does that even need to be said out loud? No,
nobody's
shit,
saying
we didn't make
otherwise.
Any money.
Yeah.
it's so funny. Anything I say I like Dave and some McGnarly 99. Dave blows. Today's the 25th anniversary of Melancholy and the Infinite Sadness. Okay, so Melancholy and the Infinite Sadness, first of all, when that came out, Smashing Pumpkins were my favorite band. I was obsessed with Smashing Pumpkins. And I had my mom, when she was going to pick me up from school, I was like, I can't believe I even got her to do this. But I think for like a month, I was like, Mom, you just, on this one day, I need you to go to the record store while I'm at school and buy this album so I can listen to it like on the way home. Like it is so important to me. And for whatever reason, she fucking did it. She like went, so like, she, you know, she picked me up at the Metro when I got out of the train and we're like in the car and there she true to her word. And my mom, as people in the stream will know, incredibly conservative Christian, right? And so we popped the CD in and it had this like lyric book. And she and I'm like, oh, it's got the lyrics. I was just like having a little fucking, you know, 13-year-old freak out. And she goes, oh, fun. Read me one of the lyrics. So I just like, okay. And I'm thinking like, this could go south. There's a chance this could go south. So I'm like, pick like the most innocent looking song I can think of, Jelly Belly. And it's like, the lyrics are immediately like, welcome to nowhere fast. Nothing here ever lasts. Down in the belly of the beast. You're nowhere. You're nowhere. You're no. And it was like, just in this story fucking sucks as I'm telling it, but like, dude, just did you have this thing with your parents where like if you're watching a movie in the basement and there's a sex scene, that is the moment that your parents are gonna like pop their head in and be like, hey, what's up, guys?
I had to watch everything with my parents, and then there would be like, there was a rule of like, one swear word's fine, two we turn it off.
Oh.
And so like I'd be watching like Saturday Night Live or Simpsons, and I'd be like, oh God, please have there only be one swear word.
In the Simpsons?
Yeah. Please only one swear word in this episode. And so there'd be like one swear word and I'd be like,
oh.
And then the second swear word would come in and I'd be like, they didn't mean it. And they would.
And it sucks all the joy out of watching it because now you're just stressed.
Absolutely. Do you ever have a thing? Like my big fight with my mom all the time was you know, would she like listen to my music, you know, I'd be like, Mom, I don't even, did you ever do this? Like, Mom, I don't even listen to the lyrics. I just like this. I just like the music. I don't even know what the lyrics say. Oh, that's what it says. That's weird. Like,
yeah. I remember I had to like, I wanted comic books. So I'd like walk to the comic book store and then I'd walk home and my mom would want to look at the comics before I could read them.
Did my dad, oh, it's like they had to have the seal that was like approved by the comic book association, Jesus, parents, man, kind of thing.
I remember one comic that my mom vetoed was because there was a guy like, I'll never forget, he was like flying a space thing. It was like a funny comic. And in this one frame, this guy's flying a spaceship. He goes like, ah, and a booger was coming out of his nose. And I remember my mom goes, really, Zach? Really? No. Because of a booger, dude. It's like,
oh, that's crazy. My parents would never do it for a booger. It was swears.
Yeah.
It was swears. The, yeah. Parents blow.
Parents blow. My mom has mellowed way the fuck out. I should say. She's very chill. Any She's thoughts a bit, on It's Always Sunny?
She loves the show.
What are your thoughts on It's Always Sunny in Philadelphia? You like that show?
I here's the thing. I do like, I embarrassingly, like, I don't watch a lot of comedy. And when it first came out, I watched a bunch of episodes from that first season.
Mm-hmm. So this was 20 years ago.
Yeah. I was like, this is great. Like, this is awesome. It's like, they're just taking the Seinfeld thing and running with it and being like, what if they were like fucking like degenerate, horrible people like that? And I like have not watched anything since then. Like, you know, like, but I loved what I've seen, but I'm very unaware, you know.
Yeah. I haven't, as with everything. I'm the same. I think I watched the first season. I really haven't stuck it. My brother, who like has a very similar sense of humor as me, he's like, you got to watch it, dude. It's fucking great. You'll love it.
I don't like comedy. I honestly don't like watching comedy.
Do you like Curb? You watch Curb, right?
I watch Curb, but it's also, there's a scarcity to that show where it doesn't come out every year. So it almost feels like an event. Mm-hmm. Like, you know, when that comes out, it's like, sometimes there's like 5 years between a season. So that like, that's enough for me to watch it. Like, you know, kind of thing. But yeah, I just kind of watch serial killer shit and like,
what's your favorite serial killer shit?
Oh, I mean, just documentaries. I like, I love that Ted Bundy thing that came out. That was fascinating. Like, I was excited about The Vow, but it kind of sucked. Trevor's like, someone's like, Trevor's so cool. I don't like comedy comedian. That's not what I'm trying to say. Like, I'm saying, dude,
fuck that person. It's very, most comedians don't watch comedy, by the way.
That's, and I'm not saying it as like, oh, this is cool. I'm just saying it as like, this is just honest. Like, I actually, you don't want to watch like shit. I don't know. I don't like it. I like documentaries. I like, and I'm not smart. I like anyone who's watched this show. Like, I'm not trying to sound smart, like, you know, like, but I like documentaries. Like, I, even in reading, I don't like fiction. Like, I like reading books about people or things that happened, kind of stuff.
But you like movies.
Yeah, I like movies.
A novel, a movie. You get where I'm going with this, right? Nonfiction, documentary.
Yeah, but I would never choose to read a movie. Like a book. If I'm going to read a book, like, that's going to take like a long time.
Well, why does time have anything to do with it?
I don't want to, like, I hate Lord of the Rings.
Okay, but that's not what we're talking about.
You know, like, no, but I hate fiction where it's like, you know, oh, this thing that didn't happen. And I'm just like, oh, this is bullshit.
It's
like,
a story.
Kind of thing.
You like, yeah, that's why I say you like movies.
Yeah, that's, but that
spending,
I
spending your time.
No, I can see it. I can see it. It's different. I don't want to have to imagine bullshit that didn't happen.
Mm. What was the last great book you read?
I hate Trevor more that he tells us what he does. Like, the more that he tells us about what he dislikes. Look, all right. The last, you know what? I really liked. So the last couple books I've read, I read one, Dirty Money, which was about the Epstein shit.
Was it good?
It was okay. I read every book about Trump that comes out, like, mm-hmm, all the Michael Cohen shit, like all that stuff.
Did you read Mary Trump's book?
I didn't. Is it good?
I haven't read it.
Oh.
But I'm like you. I read like all the headlining books about Trump. I read. Mm-hmm. I read them the day they come out usually, and it takes me 2 days to get through. I like devour them.
And it's my like, and I need to read everything in hard cover. Like I hate fucking reading paperback, and I can't get into the fucking Kindle thing.
Yeah.
Like so. Like those, I read a lot of those like biographies. But the last book I really like, really 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 was like, holy shit, this is good. And this is like this is like 2 or 3 years ago, because I've read a lot of shitty books since then. Was Sapiens.
It's so good, dude.
I love Sapiens. Good.
And yeah. Also, Homo Deus, the follow-up to Sapiens, phenomenal book, man.
Yeah.
Those books are incredible.
I also read that, but it didn't grab me like Sapiens did.
Hmm. Somebody in chat was saying, did you guys read Norm MacDonald's book? Yes, we did. And I think it's
a great book.
I think it's truly like a great book. It's better than an SNL memoir. It's like Kurt Vonnegut level good. It's fucking amazing.
I mean, he and Adam Sandler are the best people to come out of Saturday Night Live, I think. And I think he is, you know, like that book is incredible.
Bill Murray was a cast member, right?
I love Bill Murray because we all do, but like, you know, to me, I'm a Sandler guy. Mm-hmm. Like Sandler kills everybody from that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I mean, I'm with Sandler's, I feel like that's our common touchstone. That's why I wanted to do sketch, was because of his albums. Mm-hmm. So I'm with you. Norm MacDonald was the only Weekend Update anchor that Chevy said did it right. Well, who gives a fuck what Chevy Chase thinks? Chevy Chase is a bloated dick. No,
but also Norm MacDonald was the greatest of the Weekend Update.
So what? I mean, yeah, I don't know why it matters that Chevy said it. He's fuck him.
Yeah. So everyone in the, anyone who's ever met, you always hear these stories about how Chevy Chase is terrible. He's an asshole like that. I met him when I was Lorne Michaels' intern, and my job was basically all Lorne's guests. I was supposed to, like, you know, meet them at the door, bring them in, make sure they were comfortable having a good time at like Saturday Night Live, the taping, make sure they had beer, make sure all this stuff like that. And Chevy Chase was one of the nicest guys I ever met, like of his guests. Like where I like brought him up, and then you walk through this hallway to 8H, which is where they shoot Saturday Night Live. And there's all these pictures from like the 40 years of Saturday Night Live, but it really is all the first 10 years, because that's the 10 years that Lorne Michaels really cares about. Mm-hmm. Like, you know, so it's all these pictures of classic Saturday Night Live. And Chevy would just stop and just, and I'm like, I'm a fucking 20-year-old, like,
you're like,
yeah. And he'd just be like, oh, and he'd just be reminiscing about each one of the pictures and telling me about them as we walked through like that, apropos to nothing. Mm-hmm. And then you hear all this stuff about him being horrible, and, you know, time I met him, he was great.
Yeah. I mean, everyone is capable of being nice at times.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I watched Norm do stand-up a year ago, and he rambled, and he repeated the same joke about loving, I'm not going to say that word, three times over the course of the set. Like a bomb. I thought it was hilarious. So he crushed. Good deal. Good job, Norm.
Yeah, Norm's awesome. Sean O'Connor, our friend Sean O'Connor, used to open for him on tour.
Really?
Yeah. Sean O'Connor is like so tight. He's like almost like a Norm whisperer, where like Sean can talk to Norm and get him to do things, like kind of thing.
I'll bet there's not many people that can.
There's very few people that can. And so Sam Brown, you know Sam Brown. So Sam, like a couple of years ago, started a stand-up show at what's that fucking Bigfoot Lodge?
Mm-hmm.
You know, and so it was literally his first show, and Sean asked Norm, and Norm showed up and did stand-up at like Sam's first show at the Bigfoot Lodge.
That's awesome.
Like, you know, it was cool.
Okay, somebody has asked about 30,000 times, how do you handle a bully? Trevor, how do you handle a bully?
I don't know. Were you bullied?
Yeah. In junior high, there was like one year where I wouldn't say I was bullied, but I had no friends. And there was this kid, John Quo, who would follow me at lunch. I would just walk because I had no friends. So I didn't have anyone to be with. So I figured, mm-hmm. as long as my legs are moving, this was after my incident. This is mm-hmm. when my you know, the whole situation, which I've talked about on stream. You can watch it on YouTube. Zach's going to hell. I humiliated myself in front of my entire school and faculty and kids in one moment, all turned against me. So I had this thing. It was like, as long as I'm just walking, I can't be, you know, seeming like a loser. I'm going somewhere. But this kid, John, like figured out that that's what I would do. And so he would just like follow me. And he would do this thing where he would like walk behind me and go like, quah, quah, and just like kind of karate chop the back of my head. And I was such a little bitch that I like didn't have the courage to turn around and punch him. So I just like, yeah, it was pretty brutal. And he would do that for a long time. Junior high, did you get bullied?
No, I mean, like, I feel like, I think as I've gotten older, as I've looked back, I feel like I've come to the realization that I might have been the bully.
I could see that.
I had a group of friends and we did not care about anything except being funny.
Right.
You know? And so we actually, like, everyone had to walk through this one hallway to go to the lunch area. So we would set up a table there and we would always get there first and we would just sit on the table and we'd eat our lunch on the table. And we would just roast everybody as they walked by. But it wasn't like we just roasted like the kids who could take it. We'd roast the kids who couldn't. Like we'd like, you know, just basically, it was like, think of the funniest thing you could say about that motherfucker who's fucking like
to their face within earshot.
Yeah. Really loud.
Yeah.
And so that I kind of regret. But there was a year. Because I always went to very small private Christian schools. And so, like, the seniors would be in the same year as, you know, basically there wasn't other campuses. It was middle school, high school, they're all together. And I made fun of this one senior when I was in fifth grade. I just thought it was funny to keep making fun of this one senior. And I got all the other fifth graders to make fun of him, too. And so we just mocked this random senior and he got so mad that he started physically like hitting me and beating me up and stuff like that.
Sure.
He'd be like, yeah, he'd be like, stop fucking making fun of me. And like, oh, like, so I kind of got bullied there. Like he actually tried to do the swirly thing. Like yeah. He tried to put me, but it didn't work because he doesn't really like, you know, like it's easy. As long if someone's trying to put your head in the toilet, you're like, ah, fuck, 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 yeah. Fuck, fuck. Like, you know, like you can get away from it like that. But I mean, that's the closest, but it was, I was bullying him. So it wasn't, I don't know. No, I feel bad. I feel like when my kid gets to the age when he asks about bullies, I don't know what I'm going to do. Yeah. Like, because I regret a lot of that.
Whatever.
But I don't think about it a lot. I actually.
Fuck those little kids. Who cares?
It doesn't. It doesn't keep me up at night.
Yeah. Yeah. Were you really, Lunar asked a good question. Were you over 6 feet in high school?
No. No, no, no. I was regular size. And then around seventh grade, I grew so fast that I had my nose bled every fucking day for like a year.
Really?
Yeah. I just constantly have nosebleeds and I like, poof, like shot up.
Yeah, I didn't hit puberty till like, I was so, so late, dude. I think I like truly didn't hit puberty until like junior year of high school. So like I was like a junior.
11th grade?
Yeah, dude. And I looked like a kid, like a little kid.
Really?
Yeah. I mean, like, yeah, kind of. Yeah. I was like skinny and tiny and yeah, it's fucking weird. Is that even possible? What? I mean, I was just I was a very late bloomer, you know? Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Did you have like,
maybe I'm wrong. Maybe I'm
11th grade seems late.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. But I always looked about 3 years younger than I was.
Right.
When I was a kid. Always.
Oh, we've lost a lot of viewers. How did we lose a lot of viewers?
Wait, how many do we have?
538.
No way, really?
Now we have 273. Oh my God.
No, that's not right.
I'm going to use the restroom real quick. But then, did you want to wrap up in a couple minutes?
Yeah. Let's wrap it up.
All right.
Oh, wow. We're down in the 200s?
Oh, now we're at 1,000. Now we're 1,000.
Oh, okay. All right. People are fucking with us. It's just because it's late. Oh, yeah, it is a little late. I know, right? Oh, 1,000. I can live with 1,000. If it was 200, man, I would be fucking sending letters to all of you guys. I'd be like, what the fuck are we doing? What the fuck is wrong with us? Any thoughts on Kurt Vonnegut and Hunter Thompson? I mean, I love them both. Kurt Von, Cat's Cradle is fucking genius, dude. Hunter Thompson, I mean, come on. It's great, great stuff. Although it's funny, with Hunter S. Thompson, I read Hell's Angels and I was like, this is going to be the best book I've ever read. I can't wait to get going. And it's like, Hunter S. Thompson, a violent motorcycle gang. It was like before he'd found his voice. It was, I know Liturgy, dude. I know about it. And he, it's not like a real Hunter S. Thompson book so much. So it's not, yeah, that's my only complaint with him. Cormac McCarthy. Yeah, I've talked about this on stream before. I've read all of it. I fucking love him. He's like the best. What do you stream from the, why do you stream from the garage? I don't know. This is where I write. The garage is my little area. So I don't know. What do you want from me? Want to be like Hunter S. Thompson? Kill yourself. Great point. Wow. Very cool. Very cool.
Can I go back to the bullying thing for a second?
Yeah.
Because I thought about it while I was peeing. And it was the thing about it, like when we were doing it, is I don't think that we ever really thought about, like, it was like me and my three or it was four guys that always hung out together, and we would just be horrible to each other.
Right.
You know, it was just there was nothing off the table. You would just, anything you could do to like get other people to laugh at the expense of one of the four of us, uh-huh, was all fine. And you, right, couldn't get mad about it.
Right.
And I'm still friends with all of these people today. Like, you know, we're still very tight and talk all the time like that.
Was Kyle one of them?
No. But it was just whatever's the funniest thing to do in any moment, you know, like that's what we did. And that's what we did to everyone around us too. Right. But what I've learned as I got older is that they don't have the connection that we did.
Yeah, they're not part of the contract.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. And so like where you don't think about that as a kid, where you're just like, this is a really funny joke to say about, yeah, this person right now. We all laugh. That person probably goes home and fucking like is like bummed.
Yeah.
Like, you know, kind of thing. And so that's
yeah. So that, yeah, that's right.
So that's the thing that I like kind of like it, so when your first thing was like, or they were asking like, what about like, you know, bullies? I would say just tell the bully what you're feeling, because I swear to God, if anyone ever,
advice.
Really? I swear to God, if anyone ever told me like, dude, that made me like, I fucking cried last night, I'd be like, oh fuck, dude, I didn't mean that. Like, you know, you should hear what this dude just said about me. What I said about this guy. Like, you know,
dude, if I was in junior high and I roasted somebody and they were like, just so you know, I cried last night, I'd be like, you fucking bitch. I would just go in.
I don't know. I feel like I'd feel bad. I would be like, oh dude, sorry.
Oh. I'd be like, he cried. Oh man.
No, I would laugh if one of the other four cried.
Yeah.
But if some rando, like, you know.
Well, it's funny. We've been called a bully a lot in the last 2 weeks for Sam.
Yeah.
But I got to be honest. Zero remorse. No, I'm not joking. Zero. Negative remorse.
I wonder if Sam got bullied. I wonder, I mean, this would be an interesting conversation to have with Sam, because I'm sure that Sam, you know, and Timmy.
Yeah.
Probably feel like have you ever felt like I've bullied you?
One time.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, wait, I know what it is.
Do you? What do you think it is?
This is, I feel bad about this. When you came back from Vietnam.
No, that wasn't bullying. That was just a mean joke.
Okay. No. When did you think I bullied?
And it wasn't bullying. It was when we were living together in the St. George. We were roommates, and you had people in our room really late, and I wanted to go to bed, and you were trashed, and I was like, I want to go to bed, dude, and you were like. And this is embarrassing, but that was at the time where I had been doing like, I fucking hate that I'm going to talk about this, like modeling in New York. And And
by the way, you were such a good model.
Fuck you. And you were like, and it was like, it was a sensitive thing. And I was like, dude, I just want to go to bed. And you're like, okay, you beautiful model. Okay, beautiful model. And I was like, Trevor, I need to sleep. And you're like,
wait,
okay,
I was saying
model.
That.
You're a beautiful model. And I was like, dude, I need to fucking sleep. I got to get out of fucking school. And you're like, he's a beautiful model. Isn't he a beautiful model? Look how beautiful he is. He's a beautiful. And I was just like, shut the fuck up. Let me fucking sleep. Oh my God, he's so beautiful. And I like had to walk. I had to leave. I was like, I'm going to fuck. Like, and because I realized in that moment, I had no power. Like there was literally nothing I could do. You weren't going to stop. And everyone was obviously laughing. And I was just like, and the more angry I was getting, the more funny it was.
Yeah. Yeah.
So I was just like, I had to just like do a lap, you know, and just hope that you'd gotten ready to go to bed when I came home. I think that was one of the most angry I've ever been at you.
I'm sorry.
It's all right. I mean, who cares?
No, you know, but also like what's fucked up.
It's also,
like,
by the way, it's also very funny.
But when you were telling the story, like 20 some years later, and I didn't know the story, you were like, when I was a model, I was like, by the way, you were a great model. Like I did the fucking same thing again.
He just right into it.
I haven't changed. I haven't learned anything.
Oh my God. That's funny.
Yeah.
But that's also pretty light. That's not really bullying. It was just more like, you know, whatever.
But yeah,
but
I
we have definitely bullied Timmy.
I think we were bullies.
Yeah.
I don't think we had mean intentions. Like I think that we I think we took a lot of stuff for granted of like, oh, people have thick skin.
Yeah.
You know, and not in like, it's weird. It's hard to like, I don't want to say that it's in like, oh, they just didn't have thick skin. That's not the thing. Like, you know, like we were wrong, or I was wrong.
I was also wrong. In fact, when I, yeah. You know, I have made an amends to Timmy, you know, yeah. Or tried.
Someone says were LMAO. I know. I honestly am probably very, what we just proved.
No,
is like,
but we're better. We're definitely better than we were, man. For sure. We were pretty ruthless, but part of it, and this is not a justification, but like, you know, I have three brothers, you know, I grew up in an environment where it's like, it's kind of a survival mechanism that I was just like incubated in of like, you fucking give it or you're going to get it. You know what I mean? And so like, it's just like, I'm programmed when I smell blood in the water, it's like, and this is a problem for me. It always has been. I want to go at it, which is why like I have a mean tease, you know?
Right.
And I just like, I always have. And Timmy is so sweet and innocent, and he gets so mad. And when he gets mad, it's like, that's blood in the water to me. So I just want to like, you know, amp it up.
Yeah. For me, it's like, if I think of like a mean, funny thing, I can't not say it.
Well, also when like, you and I are in the same room, we tend to laugh really hard at each other's mean shit.
Because we're
so
a fucking
an
asshole.
That's ready for you. You know? So yeah.
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 I mean, I can't imagine like, you know, thinking of something that was funny and being like, oh, that's too mean. Don't say it. And then just what? Bottle it and then go home and then get like a fucking like,
and
you know,
cancer?
Like ulcer?
Are you kidding me? Yeah, I'm not going to get cancer for you, dude. I'm going to call you what I'm going to call you.
All right. Should we call it?
I think that's a good ending. Yeah, we did a good job. All right, Newsboyz. Newsboy Nation, thank you, everybody. This ruled. I'd say
you guys
this
are the
was
best.
A pretty successful Newsboyz.
They've all, I mean, here's the thing. It's like.
We've never had a lemon Newsboyz. We've had lemon Self Suck Saturdays. We've never had a lemon Newsboyz.
I guess. You guys won't even air the one.
Dude, it's gone forever. Everyone's asking where it is. They'll never see it.
Deep 60, you memory hold it, and I never even saw it.
Yep.
That bad?
Yeah.
Was it Sam? Was it Timmy?
It was Sam and Timmy.
No. Yeah, I mean, look. Keep it locked here. We'll be here next Friday. This is the show of which all others are compared against. And then we're going to do a, I will do a election night and you will check in.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah, I will definitely check in and you can call me anytime and I'll answer the phone and yeah, we'll do it. Somebody asked a good question. Why are there no more videos on the WKUK Twitch? They're all on the official WKUK VOD's channel. There's a link in our Twitch to it. If you go to our official WKUK YouTube channel, there's a link to it there. WKUK VOD YouTube? That's what I said.
Can I bring something up though?
Yeah.
I saw somebody's comment, which they were like, why am I subbing to the Twitch if all the videos are gone and I can just watch them on YouTube? Is that a thing? Is that fucked up?
Well, you're subbing to the Twitch so that you can watch it live and hang out and interact with us live.
Can you not watch it? Can you not watch this unless you're subbed?
You can, but there's the subs give you access to things like that followers don't get. And also, by the way,
like
the real answer to that question is because when you sub, you're helping us raise money for the movie. So, you know, all of this that we're doing is trying to raise money to get this movie made.
Which, by the way, we're starting. Like, we're basically kicking off this week.
Yeah,
like,
we have to get the contract ironed out, which is
we're signing the contract with the animation people, and like my goal is that you know, hopefully by like December or January we can start showing you guys like clips from it. So
that'd be amazing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
People say, wait, what movie? That's
you know
the whole reason we came back.
We need to make a video where we just describe the movie. We do like a frequently asked questions about the movie and how we're fundraising and all that stuff and pin it to our YouTube and our Twitch channel.
We got to do a Patreon or whatever.
No, I think we need to do a GoFundMe.
Oh, is that what it is?
Yeah, I think it's better.
Also, we're going to be working Civil War on Drugs is we're uploading it to Amazon.
One day.
Within this year.
Well, you know, I talked to Savakis, this is our tech friend, and he was like, you can do it in a day. I can show you how. So there's some contract shit we have to do, but we can do it soon.
We should do a big thing and like basically do a live commentary the first night it comes out. Like
that'd be fun.
All
right. Cool, dude. This was awesome.
Good seeing you, man.
All right. Later, dude. Right. So long, guys. I'm going to hang out and raid somebody. Who do you guys want to raid?
Raid AOC. She's on Twitch now.
Who do we raid?
She's polarizing though, right? Some people like her, some people don't.
I don't want to send a bunch of people in who are like, Dalekers, go fuck yourselves into AOC's thing. I don't want to do that. Raid Todd. Yeah, is Lurking Deep on? Let's do Lurking Deep. This is the guy that was headbanging. He's so fucking funny, and he'll get a kick out of it if we raid him.
Okay. How do I watch this? I'm gonna watch this.
Go to our Twitch. Or we could raid Chum. We could raid Griffin. I'll do a poll.
Raid the guy that's going to be funny.
Well,
Griffin
is also funny.
No, but you said the guy's gonna the headbang guy.
All right, let's you want to do that guy?
Yeah, he's
really funny. He will freak out and it'll be funny. So let's.
I watch you on the Twitch.
Yeah, watch our Twitch thing. All right. Yeah, I love
it. Bye, everybody. All right,
later, dudes. I'm starting the raid, and thanks for everybody that subbed. If I missed you, I apologize. We'll raid Chum tomorrow. Ending the stream. Where's my mouse? Come on, you bitch.